March 18th, 2022. This is the Red Light District Show. Holla! Yeah. It's Friday. It's payday. And there is no other place you'd rather be. This week on the Red Light District Show, we have Retrospect, the band. We'll play the license plate game.
All right.
We have the return of Sean Smart.
Coming back.
Hey. And many of other things.
All right.
Some peculiar situations.
We got things here. We got things there. We got things everywhere.
All right.
The cast from left to right. Ansel Bartley.
What up?
Return of the Mac.
Jeff Janae. Pat Mallory on the ones and twos, and what I mean ones and twos, the audios and the visuals. Ooh. Chris Barang, Phil Amoroso, Isaac Ice, and Sean Smart. I am your host, Tim Amoroso. And for the next hour or so, hour and a half, maybe two, we are going to do our best to try to entertain you. And if we attempt and we succeed, I'm gonna ask you, please click the like, click the share, probably not the share, you know, I know what it's like, right? You don't probably want to share it, but you might want to make a comment and tell us, hey, y'all suck.
That goes for both of you.
Oh, all two of you. Yeah. All right. Shit. Well, we can't have a show without talking about those gas prices.
Ooh,
geez. Man, I've almost spent, in the past week and a half, I've probably spent close to $200.
You know what I've been doing? I've been stealing babies and using the babies to pay for gasoline.
What the fuck are you talking about?
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Anyway,
don't be saying that shit here.
I just said it here.
Probably have to edit that shit out.
Yeah, well, you know, I need the money.
That's great comedy.
You don't really use your car that much, huh?
No, because like Phil points out, I'm a lazy ass that works from home.
What about you, Sean?
I don't have a car anymore. I had to sell my car. So.
I'm going to start ignoring you because you're fucking irritating me.
Yeah, he's pretty irritating right now.
you're dressed
like... just like the way he said, I
no, don't even
car.
Acknowledge him. No, he's trying to get fucking attention. I'm going to let you in on something, right?
Yes,
he
sir.
He spends fucking close to $3,000 on my credit card.
Yes, sir.
After he spends the $3,000 on my credit card... That,
shamelessly, I might add.
Okay, then he just takes off for 2 weeks because we upped that to almost, what is it, $8,000? On rock, paper, scissors?
Near $8,000. I'm at $4,500.
There's a 40, all right, 40, it's still 45.
I didn't just take off.
Christ
for two
almighty.
Weeks. I was trying
he
to
had an opportunity to win it all back and walk away with $1,300.
Like a true fucking drug addict talks about, I was trying to get back your money.
You guys didn't explain the game right. I thought I had a fallback to the last level. What was it?
Yeah, it's always somebody else's
fault.
Hey, buddy.
I literally told you like three times, like, if you go for it, you will lose everything.
You didn't tell me that. You said...
Bro, we have a show. It's up online, bro. You can go watch it.
I'm going to.
Tim, roll back.
Okay. I can't... Talk into the microphone. Make sure.
Yep. Hello?
I can't hear that.
Wow. It's okay. Tim, edit that out.
Yeah, I wonder how that slipped through our thorough sound check that we do every week.
Well, we only have ones and twos. We only have the ones and going.
Mr. Two is not here.
Yeah.
He must be on the threes then.
All right.
But anyway, you spent like $200 on fucking gas.
I don't really want to talk to you. Like, honestly, I'm at that. I'm checking right now. I don't want to talk. I think this is a work.
Yeah.
I'm not interested in what you're selling.
I'm not selling.
He looks like he's selling Kirby vacuums from what he's wearing.
Literally, all hell's broke out in this studio before the tapings.
Oh, yeah.
And literally, he's not done anything but just sit there. Like, and I'm not asking him what's wrong. I don't want to, I don't, can we just move on?
To be fair, he did complain a little, so he wasn't just sitting there.
I didn't hear it, so. Should we go, I'm going to go to weeks. How was your week?
I got rear-ended by somebody who ran away right after.
Shut up.
I'm dead serious, man. Oh, it didn't, God. Like, do... And it didn't do anything to my fucking Jeep, which I was happy for that. But yeah, I got rear-ended in a turn pocket
You didn't chase him down?
I made the turn thinking he, and then he just fucking split the other way.
Fucking Sean, is he an M-word? Sean Smart would have
no,
fucking
no,
chased
it was a white
him
guy.
Down.
It was a white guy?
Yeah.
Avenue white guy?
No, he was a derelict.
Oh.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, I mean, dirty
young?
Tank top. You know, young, not shaven.
Meth?
Neck tats.
Oh,
possible
gangster?
Meth?
Possible. Very possible meth.
Okay.
Very, very possible. Possibly. In fact, I would be surprised if there was no meth.
Okay.
Involved in that little transaction of irresponsibility there.
So then, so he hits you from behind.
Hit me from behind.
And then you pull off and he
I
just takes off.
And he keeps going.
Did you try to take a picture? Or?
No, fuck, man. I'm not a superhero, dude. Do I look like I'm that reflex oriented that I can fucking, oh, let me whip out my fucking camera. I'm not that good at it.
You didn't have your carrying powers up?
No, I was
kind
of.
How bad did he smash you?
It wasn't bad. I mean, we was in the turn pocket, so we were both coming to a stop. He just wasn't fucking paying attention. Spaced it. Bunk. So it wasn't.
Did it leave a mark?
No, there's nothing there.
Do you think he didn't think he hit you?
No, he knew he fucking hit me.
Oh, he did.
You could hear it. It was
he
loud.
Took off like a bat in the night or what?
He took off like a biatch. Like a biatch.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
so hard. Other than that?
That's not the first time that's fucking happened to me either, by the way.
Interesting.
Since I've had my Jeep, that's the third person who's fucking rear-ended me and took off.
Do you have like a bumper sticker in the back that says, hit me, I'm a bitch?
I think I do. I think I do.
Is it the areas you're driving in?
No, this is right by my house, man. I live
that's
in
why. That's exactly why.
Hey, I live in the suburbs now, all right?
Didn't someone just get shot like a couple months ago down your
that's
street?
That's irrelevant to
that's perfectly not
the
safety
oh,
of
yeah.
the neighborhood. That's relevant.
He was getting ready for work and got blasted.
Yeah, they shot the fuck out of his ass, too. That shit was tragic.
So that all makes sense.
Might be the same guy.
No, because he's
dead.
Well, you think he's a murderer, too? A meth head and a murderer? I know that's kind of, those
I
are
mean,
kind of lofty goals to put together there.
Yeah,
hey,
holes
you
in your head. Holes in your head, yeah. Holes
in your head. So what else happened? You getting pussy this week?
No, not this week. Definitely not.
Are you like texting with some girl?
I texted a couple, but I wasn't interested in going any further than.
Oh man,
you just rather masturbate.
Then in this case, yeah.
Yeah, 17.
Oh, what they were offering wasn't what I was buying. So
what were they offering?
Not what I was buying.
I mean, what is like finger blasting you?
No, you can tell like when you have those when you have a conversation with somebody and you can tell like in the first few lines of text that they're self-absorbed.
Oh, they wanted you to
like
they
bring
what?
Up shit that they want and what they you know like.
Just give her the yeah, dude.
Of, nah,
yeah,
fuck that, dude. I'm not.
Tell him after you suck my dick. Yeah.
Fucking gangster, man. I can't be doing all that shit.
It's
I just
not gangster. It's called
by,
fucking bamboozle.
A pussy that you turn away is yeah. pussy you'll never have.
This is true.
My man.
And I'm okay with that.
This is fucking lifestyle 101, baby.
I'm okay.
That's
with
a godfather,
that,
bro.
Shit. Who do you think I got?
When's the last time you got some girl?
Summer.
So almost a year.
Yeah, I guess we are getting almost back to summer again, aren't we? Yeah, almost a year.
You're not ugly.
No.
You're very
are you just weird?
Yes. Very.
Like girls don't like you?
No, I don't think I'm old enough to be to the creepy point yet. I think I'm getting there. But, you know, it's just yeah.
Your window of opportunity is closing.
It is.
You're going to be, "Oh, I remember what pussy felt like." And then you're going to have to drop $200 on a prostitute.
I'm not going to live that long, Tim.
Are you going to blast yourself?
No, dude. No.
What does that mean?
The liver going?
The popcorn lung?
Yeah, maybe right.
The popcorn.
No, fuck. I don't know, dude. I never even thought I was going to live this long when I was like young. 18? Fuck no.
That's fucking 40s. 90s talk.
Fucking okay, Kurt Cobain.
The 90s were fucking raw, bro. That shit was raw.
Speaking of raw, so last time you got pussy was a year ago?
Yeah. Well, it was under a year, but.
Well, how come you can't?
Almost a year.
How come you can't pull it in now?
Yeah.
I want a very particular thing.
What
and,
do you want?
Unless I get that.
If I was you, I would just want pussy. That's a very particular thing.
No, I don't want all that shit hanging around my life, man. That shit causes problems at times.
Well,
people slashing tires and shit, getting jealous and all that shit.
Well,
what kind of women are you getting or are you getting into with?
Crazy fucking bitches.
What the thing is,
like crazy fucking
when bitches. You look like me, you have like options, right?
when you look like you.
I want to be frightened a little bit. Like, shit, this bitch is nuts. Let's have sex now.
See, that's your problem right there. You're going from the
yes.
place. That, yeah, you
yes,
can tone it down
problem.
A little bit.
But no.
There's.
So you are turned on by crazy?
Yeah, like emotional problems and all that shit. Oh, anxiety. Oh, bro. Like fucking just. Crazy for it. I don't know why. That's just. I'm just. Hey.
Fuck.
I like flawed damaged relationships, I guess.
You're just a bad person.
Maybe.
No, for sure.
I mean, I don't try to be a good person, so it's definitely possible.
This is why, dude. This is why your parents want to break up. This is why animals are afraid of you.
My dog loves me.
I'm just saying, this is why.
Me and my dog have a wonderful relationship.
Do you want me to introduce you to my gangbang friends?
This is why you can't get hard anymore.
Not really. I don't have a problem getting hard.
I don't know.
That's never been on the list.
Pulling that
hey,
that limp taffy buddy. Around.
Fucking jacking off 15 times a day will do it. I don't have a problem with limp taffies.
Unless someone's crying. What kind of porn do you watch?
I do like
them. You like them crying, huh?
Yeah.
What kind of porn do you watch?
Yeah. Woo.
I don't know, I'm sure if you I got can a condone this. Just,
you don't condone it at all. I can. In fact, I'm pretty sure you're not even old enough to watch some of the shit.
Wait, what?
We're talking dark fantasy shit here, buddy.
No, that's borderline murder, dude. No, psychopath.
Blood or no shit like that. I'm not like into the blood or anything like that.
Are
I'm
they
just,
legal
just
age?
Extreme. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Okay, because you said you're not old enough. I go.
What do you mean, like crying?
Yeah, crying. Fucking make up a mess. Just you fucking
choking her.
Like,
yeah, oh,
like
yeah,
borderline
that's
rape
good stuff, isn't it?
Like borderline rape stuff?
No. Well, no, it's not because
it's consensual, obviously, but it's like rape.
Yeah. Dude, what?
Consensual non-consent.
Yeah.
No, I don't believe in that. You always use a safe word.
But that's the word.
What's your safe word?
I'm not telling you.
Foliage.
But I want to know when you're fucking me, when to tell you to stop.
I'll let you know before.
Hey,
okay.
Go,
see, this is right here. This is exactly why.
Close up.
This is why.
Phil's gone.
Don't look me in the eyes.
Bye, Phil.
Okay.
Don't have private conversations on why do they call me gay? I don't know, bro. Look back to this episode and then figure out why they call you gay.
Cause
it's not me.
Hey, hold on though. Just because the man enjoys a good
there's
no banging
kink
in
the ass. First of all, there's nothing wrong
gay.
With that. First of all, if you like that, there's no kink shaming here, right? Yeah. We fucking
Wait,
talk about all about it.
Kink shaming's my kink.
Okay, I'm gonna move on.
I mean, I don't know any, but I'm sure there's plenty of straight guys who like getting fucked in the ass.
It's called pegging.
You need to have that to really get off?
No, I don't need to have it. I prefer to have it.
No. You need
no,
to have
I,
it.
I don't need to have it.
Because
honestly.
You rather masturbate Phil, 8 times a day.
Oh, my gosh. I just
15.
No, Tim, I was in a relationship for 15 years where BDSM wasn't a part of it. It's not a necessity for me. It's just at this point in my life, I prefer that. So if it's not...
If
it's not someone whose fantasies are compatible with mine, then I'm not into it.
Is that possible?
And I feel
to have a real
time,
relationship?
And I feel the whole time that it's a lie at this point.
Do you
know
think
what
it's
I mean?
A phase, or is that now your new
like I feel,
establishment?
If I feel like I'm lying, then it takes away from the fun for me because I want to be trusted.
Is that your new deal of
so trust.
Is that your new normality now? Like if you can't go, you can, now that's. There's no going back from that.
I think I'm making it that way.
Okay.
Because it would be easy for me to do it the other way and just, you know, fuck for the sake of fucking. But,
You don't have, like, my dick's hard. I need to get soft.
Oh, no, I don't. I have more control over my behavior.
I'm not saying you're going to go out and rape somebody, but
no.
I mean, set something up in the future.
No, I get where you're coming from, but it's almost like an irresistible. I'm able to control that now. So it doesn't fuck with me.
I don't know. Like I don't.
Well, because because violence was always a part of my impulses when I was young.
Okay.
So I had to learn to conquer that impulse because it was getting to
do you
still go to prison.
Do the tie things?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think that's a part of your coping mechanism with that?
No, the two are unrelated.
What does it stem from?
What, that?
Your psychosis.
What psychosis are you, to which, what do you mean?
You need to degrade women to fucking come.
I don't need to do it to come. I prefer it.
But same
it's,
shit.
It's not a necessity. No, need and...
Well, that's contradicting what you're saying.
No. What he's doing is not... He's abstaining. He'd rather abstain than not have it.
Yeah.
So, right? Yes or no?
And you just said you're making that
I'd
your
rather,
normal. You're making that your normal.
I'd rather not engage than engage with something that isn't exactly what I'm looking for.
So it's either not... It's either... I don't want vanilla sex. I want everything but vanilla sex.
No. Because there's specific... It's specific. It's degrading women.
That's not vanilla sex. There's more to it. There's more to the kink of it than that too. It's the restraint. It's the dichotomy of consent and within the relationship itself.
Like the power exchange.
It's the conversations that occur before and after. You know, it's all of that.
Do you get somewhat kind of turned on and off by yourself this not allowing you to do that? Not allowing you to do that? Like, abstaining
there,
from it?
There's an aspect of that to it, and yeah. it's part of just self-control and emotional control.
Yeah.
And understanding that it does exist. But once you learn about yourself to that point, it becomes easy to not give in to the impulse in such a way.
Saving it for the
yeah.
time. Yeah.
Yeah. Because it's not repression for me. Because I don't lie to people about who I am.
But the thing is, you're seeking out, like, that's what you want.
Mm-hmm.
You're abstaining from normal relationships,
oh, yes.
which society would deem normal.
Oh, yeah.
But you want to get in a relationship like that, which will ultimately fail.
Yeah.
Okay. So with that being said, are you just destined to just be solo for the rest of your life?
Maybe, but life doesn't usually work like that, right? What you don't expect to happen happens.
Yeah.
And you don't really have control over it. So saying that I just want to go in that direction, you know, it doesn't mean that you're going to run into each and everything that's in that direction.
Do you have low self-esteem?
No.
Then what is that, like, needing somebody who's broken to want you?
Because for me, it's more about it. I'm someone who throughout my life, I've never been trusted just because of what I am.
What does
like,
that mean?
People would never take the time to learn who I am just because what I am,
what
where
mean,
I come from.
Black or white or a gangster?
It's black, Muslim. Being a street kid, you know, being most of my life obviously a street kid, you know. So I've
especially
never had,
in the 90s.
So I've never had, yeah, because in the 90s it was easy for people just to fucking write you off.
You write
know?
You,
were,
oh, for
you
sure.
were a subcategory and you were a fucking, you're a subcategory. That's it.
Yeah.
So for me to have that level of trust from another person,
that's what gets you off.
Reason of existence.
That's what gets you off.
Yeah. So
that
more,
so many people have written you off.
So the more
that the one person that thinks you're special in that way.
Yeah.
But still accepts you for
being.
Yeah.
So the more risky the behavior, the greater level of trust and communication.
Do you bust harder?
There has to be. Oh yeah.
You bust
oh,
harder?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
What does that mean?
I'll
bust
knock
harder.
A fucking wall down, buddy.
Ropes.
Blues. Well, it just, you know, more volume, more intense, feels better.
Is that like, or for instance, when you're on Molly and you bust, that's a fucking.
You know,
experience.
I've never done Molly before.
I've never
before.
Done that either.
I've done X, and they say it's similar, but I've never done.
No, Molly's pure, dude.
Yeah, I don't know.
X is you feel when you do X.
X is you spend a fucking hour and a half leaning against a wall.
No,
just
it's
because
not.
It's right. it's
X
just
makes
right.
you feel good, but there it's not clean.
It's warm.
It feels good, but then there's a head thing that goes on and a body thing, and you're just done. Molly is nice. Let's
yeah,
go.
There's no the down isn't as bad.
Yeah,
that's cool.
All right, we're spending a lot of time.
Yeah,
on
you
got
to move on.
And I like that. And thank you for being so fucking open with that. That was cool. This is the first time I really got to interview you like that.
Thank you
well, there was no comedy element to it. I'm just letting you know.
Thank you for breaking down the wall there.
What's up, dude?
With your volume.
Hi.
I got mad at you this week, dude.
Yeah. Yeah. I know.
Well, I found out that Issac was just playing me. So.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
I was going to make you. That's why I put the
song.
No.
You made a song about me?
No, I was going to.
Oh.
But I put the thumbnail for last week's show.
Like the first time
me looking at you.
Disappointed for not making
was
a
it?
Song.
It is.
For,
I see it.
Oh.
Oh, the thumbnail?
Yeah, it was. Yeah, I showed it to Ice. Yeah, so the reason why I got mad at Jeff is, all right.
If I can get some Wi-Fi in here.
If we have two, I mean, there's two people that are like, Dennis and I was under assumption it was Jeff, but it's obviously Ice, that they are, like I have long days, right? And they want to complain about me leaving a meeting in their mind, abruptly, but it's just a fucking paint a narrative on me.
Do you want me to tell you exactly what happened now?
I pretty much know, but yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so the time you left
the Stefan show,
you left one time, the first time early, right? And we were all like, and we were all just
it was still over an hour, but
yeah.
Go ahead.
And we were just all like, oh,
or about an hour.
We were like, what are we supposed to do? So we all had like a mini meeting, and then we were all like, all right, bye. Then you did it the second time. And then Dennis was like, he started doing his little thing that later on we'll find out what we'll talk about it.
Dennis fucking explodes.
Yeah. So he starts a little bit showing his little, you know, steam starting to come off. He goes, so then I'm like, oh, here we go. So I'm like, and then I chime in with like, yeah, this guy just leaves. And then all of a sudden, I was like, I know, he didn't even say nothing. And then this guy champs is like, I know, he kind of did leave. So then that starts a whole, like, 10-minute conversation about how you fucking just leave and, like, what are we supposed to do on the show now? Like, we don't even know what we're doing.
That's stupid. If it is him or it is you or you, that's fucking retarded. Because I sit there for a fucking hour. And if you guys don't know what's going on after an hour, then I don't know what to say. You guys are just idiots.
I know the skinny. I was just stirring the pot.
Like, with Stefan, I deliberately said during the Stefan meeting, we don't do nothing. We're just there for the ride.
Yeah.
What do we do? I just told you what to do. So it's obviously idiocracy that's in the room.
But why are you surprised at that? You know who we are.
Because it's not real. They're not really upset about it. Dennis just wants to be mad about something.
Wait, oh, you have to see to them, like you're the little soccer ball and it's rolling down the road with them.
No, but this is,
they want to kick it.
I'm just telling you, those days are fucking over.
No, but this has been a constant, like almost a month of Dennis. And it kind of started rooted with like him not being talked to in the beginning of the show. Like he first,
this was going on in December though too.
Well, this also kind of
started. Even ask Chris.
This also
Chris, wasn't he getting mad in December? About not starting on time and things like that. But we deliberately say in December, we start a little later. Well, I mean, this is the first time we started late since December.
And then it also started stemming when we started fucking with him because he started acting up, right? He goes, oh, play the music. It started with the music. And it started with all this other stuff, right? And he started getting annoyed. And then I was like, all right, we're fucking with him because that's what we fucking do on the show. We fucking, like, if someone gets annoyed, we fucking go at it. Just like this guy. Like, I said something and he fucking blew up.
Yeah,
that's different.
Get there.
But then it started snowballing where he was just like, and then like, oh. You guys don't talk to me for 10 minutes. And then it turned in, and we talked about it earlier on this week where we talked about it, like how we were fucking with him and then no one talked to him. And then he made that into a bit. He changed the narrative, but then it kept on going. So then when it came back full circle in the meeting where he was like, he just left. And I was like, I know, what a fuck. And then I'm like, yeah, what a fucking dick. And then it turned into this whole, and then the wolf pack, well, I don't know if he did it on for real or purpose or like he was just chiming in. And then Jeff said, he didn't leave abruptly. So then it started this whole thing, and I just let that narrative go.
Well, I was editing the film, and it was just on him and him, Jeff and Pat. And me and you were talking about it, and these two are fucking, or not really you, you're just playing along with him, but you're making faces. And when you make it...
During the podcast?
Yes, during the podcast.
Oh.
And I got fucking, I saw red. I was like, motherfucker. On top of what he was telling me.
You'll have to show me that because I don't know what I was making faces at.
It was me. I was getting mad at him.
Right now, you kind of look like you're making a face. I mean, I know you're not, but yeah. You know, it's just you have the face that looks like you're making
and
a
that
face.
Was true. Last week, I did have some aside conversations with Pat about you would make a little quiet joke about something that only I would get.
It wasn't that. It was in my head.
Uh-huh.
I'm arguing with him.
Uh-huh.
And I'm telling him he's being a little bitch.
And you're thinking that I'm thinking what you're saying is dumb, so I'm rolling my eyes at you or something?
Yeah, well,
I know you guys were talking, but it seemed like you guys were talking about what we're talking about.
It's just your demeanor.
I need to see the clip, to be completely honest. I'll be able to tell you what I'm rolling my eyes at.
It's your demeanor.
Probably. Very...
A little cunty.
The moment I saw that, I call this guy up.
Uh-huh.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay.
And do I not flip out? I was pissed.
Like, I go, no, I got it. I have to hear it.
Oh. I didn't hear it. This is the first I'm hearing about it.
I was like, and then that night, you're like, you're being a little bitch in the meeting, too.
Yeah.
You're going to leave. If you don't need, you're pulling Phil.
Yeah.
I don't need to be here. Fuck you guys. Like, yes or no?
Yeah, I had fun with that. Yeah.
At least you admit it.
Yeah, no, I did. I did because I was, yeah, I was left in the parking lot for like an hour from my work, and nobody was there for the training. I was a little pissed about that. So when you guys were asking about like how was my work, I'm like, I don't even want to fucking talk about it.
You guys talk about it, I'm gonna leave.
Yeah, because I just didn't want that to be the whole meeting. I wanted to just get right to it, and I had a lot of editing to do. You know, so I was frustrated.
And then this guy, you're over here doing it, and then this guy's laughing. So if you're wondering why he wasn't laughing that you were being, he was laughing because he knows I was pissed off.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well. Yeah.
Huh.
You're very pissed off.
You're waiting for me to.
Oh, jump on the.
Well, hey, you know, if I offended anybody, I'm sorry.
But then you did a little wah, and I heard it. You did a little wah, because you were like, fine, we'll move, but then he hit you with a little jab. Like,
you didn't hear the wah? The little wah?
No, I did. I did.
Wah.
Yeah, I did hear that, yeah.
So I apologize, but not sorry that I did all that.
It did, like,
that's fine.
Yeah. It did, like, even during the meeting, you were still fucking going. I was like, all right, because in the meeting we go, two goods, one bad. Right, because we wanted to be double positive than we are negative. And this guy goes, well, all I know, shit on me, shit on Phil, shit on Pat, shit on Ice. The end.
Yeah. Five negative. I mean, you can watch the show. That's all I remember, dude.
And then what was my response?
I don't remember. Well, I don't pay attention during the meetings.
I didn't shit on Pat.
Yeah, and then I said, well, you kind of did because we totally glossed over his week.
No, but that's
so
the way
that
it
was
is.
The thing.
The thing is, I'm not sure. Someone's week is about to get glossed over because we're spending a lot of time on this. I don't know who it's going to be. So make sure you stand up for that person, too.
Yeah, next week.
Yep, we'll
during
do.
The meeting. Yeah. Oh, did I go with how was your week?
No, but okay. You can gloss over my week if you want me to be the guy.
No.
Mine wasn't that interesting. I just went to work. I watched a couple of movies. I saw Batman.
You
I saw Matrix.
Went to work?
Yeah, I did. I'm back at work now. So.
Give it up for work, you guys.
All right.
Yeah.
You missed it. This guy gets paid a lot of money.
A lot of money.
And
gas money.
Complaints.
Actually, you know what?
Is this true?
Yeah. So, well, there's a lot.
Well,
there's a lot more to it.
That's what I mean.
There's
like,
a lot more
cunty.
To it. No, there's. Well, hey.
He's like.
Know, there's a lot more
pictures
to it.
At schools, and he's like, "Can you believe these guys? I need to type in their names for them."
It's more than just typing their names for them. You know, it's you're supposed
Am
to
I
have
far
all
off?
Of it. But hey, when you're supposed off. To ask a preschooler, "Hey kid, what's your name?" I don't know. Hey teacher, do you have like a list of their names? Oh no, we gave you all that. Well, fuck, this kid doesn't know his name. Yeah, I don't know it either. You're his teacher.
Does that piss you off?
Can you go to the?
Do you have
it's
to like?
Just,
you have to be polite.
Don't they have
it's
a,
like, I want to fucking
desk
strangle
with
you.
Their name
right
no, they don't. But they
show motherfucking vote. We're voting. Do you like your job? Raise your hand.
I mean, kind of. I mean.
John, you just don't want to be left out. Shut up. You didn't. You weren't feeling it then. You're not feeling it now.
Right, is there any part of your job that sucks?
Okay. To be fair, yes, sure. Like I am pretty salty about a lot of stuff. I didn't tell the whole story about like.
But he
listen.
He
minutes,
can afford his $1,800 rent and have shit left over to.
You pay
to
$1,800 a month.
Yes.
Jesus Christ.
But that's the lowest fucking rent that you can get in Ventura without living on the avenue.
Well,
yes, it is.
That's not true.
That's not true at all.
What about Todd Ranch?
How much is that? Look
Todd
it up
Ranch?
Right now. Look it up right now.
It's
where
about
is that?
$1,500-$1,600.
Where is that?
For a two-bedroom.
Todd Ranch is next to the water park.
The water
that's
park.
That's where he used to live.
Yeah, Kimball.
He used to live there.
That's near Pettit and everything. That's nice
that's
place.
Where we used, that was what the
a lot of white
look up the rent right now. Dude, it's gone up
well,
exponentially.
Probably now, yeah.
Exponentially.
Everything but you've been there for a while.
It's like a travel price.
Yes, but they went up from.
But you're saying
I
that's the cheapest on the avenue. That's not true.
When we were looking,
cheap,
it was
the
cheapest the place. Everything. It was 15.
What's wrong with the avenue, first of all?
I don't want
to
live there.
The avenue. What are you saying about?
Have
my
you?
I don't want to live
you
there.
Been there lately?
I just wanted to know.
I don't want to live there.
What's wrong with it?
I mean, it's
not
terrible.
Yeah, it's not good.
It's getting gentrified.
There's a whole bunch of white people.
There's a 7-Eleven.
Yeah, that's right. See, what's wrong?
I don't. I just don't want to live there.
There's a 7-Eleven there. It's fine.
Oh,
it's the wrong kind of white people, though, Chris.
It's the right. It's the white.
It's the wrong kind. It's the wrong kind of white people.
It's the white.
I live on the avenue.
No, it's the white people. Exactly.
Yeah, look at you. Exactly.
Perfect.
What happened to you?
You're a degenerate.
You look like you just hit fucking Ansel's car.
Yeah.
Yeah, like you were the
you
guy.
You owe
me
the amount of money I owe a credit card.
$2,300.
Oh, my God. That is not the number. But we're going to get back to that.
Nice.
We're going to get back to your number, I'm sure. Glossing over weeks.
I'm getting very disinterested in this.
Well, I went back to work. Actually, you guys complaining about me complaining about work and stuff actually helped me like go, yeah, you know what? I should just deal with it.
So and if you keep I dealt complaining, with it. Are you going to become like the manager?
No, I actually found out some pretty cool stuff that's going to start happening around there soon, because I guess the upper company, Shutterfly, is coming in saying, hey, Life Touch, you're doing a shit fuck job at whatever you're doing over here. You're not paying employees anything. And wow. Like, yeah. So
it's a fucking war.
So we're getting some cool stuff. But then I had my first day of work. I worked with the most annoying guy in the company, and I didn't want to strangle him at the end of the day, so that was nice. And I saw some movies. And I was finally saw Matrix.
And I was definitely going to fucking make a song about you.
I would have loved that.
Well, right. Keep it up.
I will. Yeah, dude, I was so excited when you started playing songs. I'm like, oh, fuck, is there one for me? Not this week, though. Well, I can dream.
See, like, it's funny how people want a song by me, but this guy takes it as I just pick on him. Do you not see the legend?
It's Phil.
There's legendary songs made about you.
Indeed.
Legendary.
And then like an old album could be put on.
We can have a Phil out. Yeah, well, if we
make a two-disc set.
Like, that was a different time we lived in then. We can say, oh, you're gay, and oh, this. Like, there was a whole collection of Phil is gay.
Just back that album.
Because of the, remember how you were saying big guys?
Like, we'd need a separate album just for the gay songs. Part,
yeah. Were you
Phil being gay?
Were you there?
Phil's
with
gayest
the,
hits.
The big gays? That was funny. That was one of the. All right, how was your week? I'm going
to. Yeah,
done.
Skip over me. I'm the done. Russell I'm Crow. Done. I don't got anything to say.
Come on, Pat.
Okay.
Tell us about it.
I've been getting a ton fuck of hours because one of my coworkers recently got fired from my job. Pretty much.
What does ton fuck mean to you? Like 12?
No. I was getting about 3 to 4 hours, and now I'm getting twice that much.
Who's ton fuck? That's 6 to 8 hours. That's. Yeah. That's almost a regular shift.
Okay, yes. So you're working regular. Okay.
So you're working like a man. Okay,
yeah. Perfect. Yes. So, yes. We're going to be working like a man soon. Let me tell you more. So I'd say about maybe Monday, I came in to relieve a dude from the job, you know, morning shift to night shift.
That's usually how it goes, yeah.
That's how it goes, yeah.
Is this McDonald's or something that you're working at?
Budweiser has like a Long Island iced tea type thing with like Coke. Like, it's like brandy. Rum.
Fuck.
So if he worked on Red Light, I would make a song about him. Go ahead.
Pretty much. And so he's just getting lit at the kiosk where we work. And I'm like, okay, so you can't be doing this. Now, as much as I love weed and I love drinking, and I love how much you can work, which is okay amount, you can't be doing this at the job. And I tell him, like, hey.
Oh, hold on. Can you pause right there?
Yeah.
You don't think it's funny that Pat is telling a guy this?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Continue.
I'm surprised he wasn't telling Jeff this.
There's definitely some irony.
Two or three days later, my coworker calls and is like, hey, I just relieved the delinquent from the shift, and you won't believe what the fuck just happened. So he got into work.
Okay.
And this dude's not at the kiosk. He's missing. His car is there, and he's just going, okay, is he in the storage container? He opens up the storage container, and lo and behold, our delinquent coworker is getting fucked in the ass by another dude.
You're not. You're serious. Serious.
That
holy
is
shit.
Awesome.
In a shipping container?
You got to see that?
Fuck yeah.
I got to see that. My
I got to see the shipping container.
What did it smell like?
It smells like homeless people piss because homeless people piss on it.
Awesome. Okay.
So he's getting railed, right? And my coworker's like, you know, in awe going, what the fuck's going on? And the other guy turns, realizes he got busted, starts
close the door, your mother's busy.
Pretty much. With his dick out and everything, bum rushes him to close the door going, get the fuck out of here! You're not allowed in here! Stop that! No! Stop! No! Go away! Type
so that's what happened. Was
the person that works with you getting fucked?
Yes.
Whoa, okay. He's a receiver. Okay.
Yeah,
he's a receiver. Yeah. And so, you know, my
wide
coworker
out.
Literally just goes, gets mentally cleansed, calls the manager, calls me, just cleans his brain of the situation that
hold
he
hold on, can I interrupt
into.
You for you'd quit if you walked into a room and saw your coworker getting fucked in the ass.
Yeah.
Right?
100%.
Right, why can't you get this ability from this?
Yeah.
No, I'm dead serious.
Dude, you should exactly yeah. say that you were
not
traumatized. And fucking,
that's very traumatic. Yeah.
You have to spread your fucking butter onto a bread with a
spoon cannot
now.
Fuck with. I cannot fuck with containers no more.
Exactly.
You're
I can't
afraid
do my
of
shopping
containers.
The cherry on top is when he comes in and he's like, okay, I actually have to be working now. And he goes in, and the other coworker, the delinquent, is smoking crack in the kiosk as like a cool down of getting fucked, I guess.
Oh, he just doesn't give a fuck.
I think he doesn't give a fuck.
I think that's a reward after.
Exactly. I think he was doing like party for play. Yeah, some people have a cigarette. Crack, but you can afford my crack.
Some people light some crack.
Yeah, that's exactly what that was.
Next thing I know, my manager's calling me within like 4 hours after my coworker called me to warn me that people were going elsewhere. Pretty much just telling me, hey, can you cover this shift, this shift, this shift, and this shift? And I'm like, please give me more money. So that was my week.
All right, so wait, can I recap something? You said you had to relieve a dude, and the dude that you were supposed to relieve was getting railed in the ass.
He was the one doing the fucking.
No,
I understand what's happening. Good.
Okay, so do you think because he was smoking crack afterwards that this was an exchange? Like he didn't have money, so he was getting butt fucked for the crack?
Yes, it's a common practice, but, I believe, for party for play.
But also, crack can be used as a sex drug.
Yeah.
Okay.
It loosens up the butthole.
But that's after.
But he was
crack,
after.
Though.
His butthole's already loose.
He might have some extra. Dude, once you do coke, have you ever done coke?
Nope.
You don't.
I did edibles
stop.
Once.
That's nowhere near the same.
Yeah.
That's about it.
I had an aspirin.
Have you ever?
Yeah.
Like, no, I've had an aspirin.
One too many Flintstones gummies. you know, that's crazy.
I think me and Ansel were in the same hole at the same time with the cocaine
thing.
No.
Same hole? Wait. You need a different analogy.
Real quick.
Am I burning you out? I will edit it out. I don't give a fuck.
I don't know what you're talking about, Tim.
Okay.
Can you put a timestamp where he like quickly retracts this? No.
So there was a time where me and Ansel had the same dealer.
Same hole?
No, dealer for drug, for coke. What? And we were fucking
golf and stuff.
Ansel was more than me.
It was long.
No, Ansel, you'd get 8 balls on the reg.
What the fuck?
Yeah, dude, I would.
And I would just get $60 worth.
Sometimes 2 a week.
You would be dropping like C notes on that?
Yeah, oh yeah.
$200-$400.
It got
to rent. You said it was owed rent.
Rent was fine.
That. You saying that you owed rent like money to this dude.
Yeah.
Oh, you guys had like a whole like C.
Yeah. Okay. He owed money.
I paid it all off, but I mean, there was that time where it was like, yeah, it's in there. I ain't selling this shit.
And then like he was like, hey, so blah 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 offered this and that.
That was a fucking bender, Tim. Holy shit. Why'd you have
that guy?
That
oh, no, that
that time in particular.
It was here, right?
I had people hitting me up too, like, hey, that stuff's really sell me some of that. And like, I'm not a drug dealer. Leave me alone. I gotta go. Stop.
This is back when you could party, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Without fucking caught up in fentanyl. But I mean, you ever wonder like how close we were like to getting a fentanyl or something?
We might have got out at just the right time, bro, because it was getting pretty dark at the end there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like those last couple batches were fairly questionable.
And I know he was
definitely
cutting it with something else.
Definitely.
When I noticed that he was cutting it with something else,
definitely
that's when I walked away.
I used to wash his shit. And you'd lose like maybe 10-15% of it.
What do you mean wash it?
Yeah. What?
You can burn out the impurities with other chemicals.
Okay, fucking Walter
and
White.
Leave it more pure version of cocaine.
Like with what?
I don't want to say it on the air.
Ammonia.
Stop it. Bleach, ammonia.
No, it's a hydrogenated acetone.
Where do you buy that at?
Fucking
fruit juice.
Online,
yeah.
Usually, or you can get it at chemical supply store.
Oh shit, dude, that's amazing.
Fucking.
It's not.
Can
it's
we
not.
Use that on Lit
will
Science?
Will it burn out?
Can we have an episode of Lit Science?
Yes,
on this?
It will.
Yes, you can't. Because
you shouldn't even told me that.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Now, on
but
next,
you're gonna
on the next
lose,
episode,
you're gonna lose the entire cut and then some. So. If
so you're
cut,
probably with a third of it left.
If it's cut with fent, you're probably gonna lose about 20-30% of it.
Perfect.
Does it just dissolve it?
Or
how do you separate
it? And then when you filter it, it stays behind in the filter. It doesn't pass through the filter because it bonds it with a heavier,
like how you,
with a heavier,
how you
with a heavier chemical.
Your nose, but you just did that right.
Hey, it takes a while. It takes a few days.
Have you ever done coke? No. Have you ever done coke?
No.
Just ask me.
Have you ever done coke?
Of course I did.
I mean, yeah. Back in the 80s, yeah, right?
70s.
70s?
Yeah, dude.
Oh, he had the good.
Well, no.
That was disco coke right there.
Oh, it was disco coke.
That's a good. Yeah.
It's not even the same, huh?
Oh, no.
Like Ludes and Quaaludes?
Oh, yeah.
Not the same. Dude. Now Quaaludes aren't the same as back then Quaaludes.
It's like blue meth and clear meth, bro.
Don't fuck with meth.
It's like PTP.
Hold on. You've never done coke?
Nope.
Have you done coke? Chris? Have you done coke?
He hasn't done anything.
Yes.
You have?
Yes.
Fuck.
Why do you say it like you're even trying to get?
I'm gonna get to him. All right, dude. Congratulations. You saw a dude get fucked in the ass. Dude. Okay. Well, that's a pretty good story.
It's a good story. I told you.
Yeah, I felt like you were the one seeing it the way you told it. It was very, very nice.
All right, Dad. I'm gonna start off with I apologize, but sometimes you make me freaking so furious. Like you don't. It seems like sometimes you don't take in consideration me. Ever. That's the way I feel. And I know it's not true in my heart, but in the deep, dark reality, like, in the moment when I'm there, it seems like you intentionally do things to make me upset. And I just apologize. I fucking lose it because most of the time I bottle that shit up. Because we don't talk about things. I learned that from you. Your life's your life. My life's my life. That's, you know, what you do. So I apologize. I didn't mean to get that upset, but... And, like, whatever you guys have going on, do not bring me into it no more. Like, promise. I don't give a fuck. I don't want... Do not bring me into it.
No, you fucking... You drew the bow back, buddy. I was watching it.
Yes.
I was watching that there. That was...
You know exactly what you did, Ice?
All I said was Joe Biden is his boy. And
no, there was...
I'll bet Ike...
That's literally why he walked... Phil,
okay. I'll bet Ike.
Shut up.
What? See, this is what I'm talking about.
That's my pen. That's my pen.
I know it's been here.
Okay, I don't want. Ice, don't steal it.
I'll bet Ike would be really good at inciting a riot. Like that would be like some shit that would be really.
Like
really
if it's good. Not him fucking with me, it's you fucking with him to fuck with me.
Time out.
Pause. Okay, I'll pause this.
Who fucked with my cup? He did, right? Okay,
I'm assuming.
Yeah,
he ruined my fucking.
Talking to the microphone, please.
I didn't. First of all,
then what are you fucking crying?
I'm the guy that eats all the fucking hot sauce on the show, and you're gonna be like, I'm gonna get him real good. I'm gonna put fucking hot sauce on fucking little jalapeno shit on my cup. Well, you got me damn right, Phil.
No, but the thing is, he blamed me at first.
Who?
And you?
No, I didn't.
You were like, did you do it?
Well,
you
didn't ask me. But then I go, no, it's not you.
What would I do if
you
I was...
You fucking rub your balls and dick and
for
whatever.
For sure.
No, that's you.
I'm going to dick you up.
Yes. And then I go, it has to be him. And then I go, and then he's like, why would I do that? I didn't do that. I'm like, all right, cool, dude. Whatever. And then I'm not even mad you did that. That's actually like, I'm going to go ahead.
And I think it's cool that you're fucking with
him. Yeah, that was fine. I didn't care about that. And then he starts getting all cranky. And then we're talking about fucking this whole thing with Biden. And I go, hey, your boy. And then he fucking gets
but
mad.
You always say shit like that.
You voted for him.
No, I didn't. And I already fucking told you that.
Well.
How many times do I have to fucking say
no, but the thing
before
is.
Before you get the idea. I mean, right, what's your problem?
You
man?
Didn't vote for him.
I didn't
know
vote
you
for anybody last time.
But
I didn't even vote.
Right. But when we, in our discussion, like, it was you and Ansel sticking up for Biden. In that time of the year.
Well, as long as it was against Trump, I don't give a fuck. If it was Mickey Mouse, I'd still go against Trump with anybody.
Well, now we're regretting that, right?
Huh?
Now we're regretting it.
Well.
That's why I call me
away. It is the way it is. So I just wanted to just say, to close that chapter, they're not our friends. Trump's not our friend. Biden's not our friend. No one's our friend.
Oh, Trump's your best buddy, and you know
it. No one is our friend.
He would suck his dick if he whipped it out in front of you.
No,
you know
Dad, I'm talking about politicians.
Yeah.
No one's our friend. No one wants what's good for us. Can we all agree on that?
I agree.
Yes. Can we all agree that they all are trying to just rack? Because how come someone gets a 21% raise last year, but then inflation 7 to 9%? You shouldn't be getting 21% raises in a pandemic.
And why are we paying this much for gas when we only buy 2% from Russia? Why do we all of a sudden have to pay this much for fucking gas?
Well,
that's my
a lot of the production in the United States.
Because a lot of countries get a lot of oil from Russia.
Yeah, we get.
And without that in the market as a whole now, the price goes up for everybody.
Yes. But then also we stopped, we were having a conversation about the 50-50. You know, I'm just gonna go with what your numbers was because that's what you know.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're not producing enough gas in this country.
Well, as far as I understand, we're not one of the major producers in the world.
Right, and we're not doing it.
We stopped because of the Green Deal.
Yes.
No, it was stopped apart. Because of the pandemic.
Things
haven't gotten going to the full steam of what they were before the pandemic because they're slow playing it to make the profit off of low supply.
Well, now they're blaming Russia for it now.
But there's also the EOs.
That adds to it. But the bottom line is the oil-selling nations of the world want to do it slowly at this point so they can recoup profits.
And also, exactly.
Sell electric cars right now?
The thing, that's stupid too, because what most electric companies are used, right? Fossil fuels.
Well, here's my fucking gripe with that.
Hold on, let me close this one and I'll go to you. Never mind, I forgot. Go.
Well, here's my gripe with that. They're over here pushing electric cars, right? And then a reporter asked fucking Secretary fucking Redhead is like, hey, does President Biden own a fucking electric car? Because he likes to go and say, well, do this, do that. And she dodged the question. No, of course the president doesn't have a fucking electric car.
Biden doesn't drive no fucking
electric car. They don't
fucking,
none of these motherfuckers have electric cars. And you know how much an electric car fucking costs? Fucking, it's way cheaper to get a used, well, even the newer cars or used cars are still expensive.
Hold on, ADD. I was talking about the executive orders that were signed on his first day in office. A lot of them were effective on the production of oil and gas in the United States. Not a lot of them, 3 or 4 of them, major ones, including the closing of the Keystone Pipeline.
Within that same period, there were also many that offset it. He signed more drilling leases now than...
But we're not even started.
There's too much red tape.
No, the only thing that we're not initiating as far as like new oil coming in is the phase 4 of the pipeline, which it was irrelevant anyway because it's a small amount of oil. It went through ancestral land, so you'll spend more money building the damn thing that you'll ever recoup off.
No, that's not true. Within a certain amount of time. And this is another thing with, if you want to talk about the Green New Deal and all that shit, the trains tracks in the United States that transport the oil instead of that pipeline are now using extra resources or fossil fuels to transport that oil.
Well, yeah, but none of that's from the Green New Deal. No legislation was ever finalized from that. That nothing came out of that.
But
that was just an idea for a framework.
The framework around it is determining other things that we're doing.
But the reasons behind the spike have more to do with other economic issues.
It's a bunch of issues. It's not just one.
But don't we have a bunch of oil reserve that we haven't even tapped into?
Well, yeah, man, but that's not for that.
You said something interesting earlier today about the... Or was it, I'm not sure one of you were saying about we have the second highest amount of oil found in 2018 or something?
Our larger reserves was discovered to be
a lot bigger.
And it's
the second in a bigger in the whole world, right?
It's one of the largest.
But then the White House is freaking talking about how we want to cease our dependency on foreign oil, but we have all that shit here.
Look, you can't listen to any of that. They're only saying things that they think people want to hear.
But we're not.
It's high school.
Are people that stupid? We're not stupid.
Most people are.
Well, I mean, not this group.
I hate to tell you, but there's a lot of dumb fuckers out there, and that's fine.
And you can tell because people are regurgitating things on social media that don't really make even sense.
Yeah, I'm getting dumber every year.
Yeah.
But the thing I don't understand is why are we exporting oil and importing oil? Why do we have to import oil?
Because we have created a system throughout the world where value of currency and value of oil is based and weighted against our currency, our dollar, as the reserve.
Yes.
So in order to perpetuate the use of our dollar as a commodity buying property, we participate in that circle and initiate it to keep it artificially inflated. And it's also a means of exporting our inflation to other markets by setting the tone and establishing the industry rhythm in that way.
And then what they're also doing is when you are, when we have all these, when they write legislation and they put in there things like, this amount of money goes to this country, this amount of money goes to that country, it's mainly to make the dollar stronger.
Absolutely.
100%.
All like of that trade only exists to bolster the dollar.
The dollar.
That's so why that trade is
when
there.
You see $10 billion going to Ukraine, mm-hmm. what's happening really is, hey, we'll give you – the Iggy is we'll give you this much, but make sure you put my son on the board of Burisma.
Yeah.
Or you put this guy's son and this guy's son in you know, Singapore or Ukraine or everywhere.
The creation of artificial demand. And here's the deal. And a lot of this aid money that we're giving to a lot of these countries, we're not giving it to them in dollars. We're actually converting our dollars into their currency, and then when they want to purchase commodities with it, they have to convert those currency in their dollars back to our dollars.
And there's a loss.
They can purchase it.
And a lot of times there's a loss.
So they take a loss. We're beating them over head. We're beating them over the head when they come in the door and when they walk out of the door.
And when they're in the door, because people are getting kickbacks.
They're getting fucked in the ass, like in the fucking cart.
All right. Always some issue. I'm gonna go there. How was your week?
Nothing exciting, just a typical week. Go to work.
What happened? Are they week. Fucking with you at work? We can go
no,
to.
There's just a lot of fucking yeah. work, and there's no, there's nobody applying for the jobs. We need at least three more maintenance people.
Are they
have,
not? Are they we, not giving enough
talk?
Pen shirts?
And there's what we've got over 500 apartments, 200 something villas, and all this, and like about 600 people, and. There's
you,
two of us doing the job that five people should be doing, and it's a fucking nightmare. Because like nobody wants to apply for any kind of job.
Can I get a job application?
You wouldn't know how to do it.
Cool.
He just said he needed yeah. people.
Yeah, but we need stupid people, and we don't need.
How do you know what he knows how to do?
Okay.
I took occupational woodworking in high school.
Well, we're not doing woodworking.
A lot of welding here and there, so I
know. Okay.
He's a welder and a woodworker. You can handle it.
So hold on. Is there people at work fucking with you, talking shit?
No.
Because if there is, you show me a picture of them. We'll get them.
Yeah, we'll fuck them up, dude.
Yeah. Just show me a picture. We'll come up with like things for you to say to them.
I mean, I know we give you a lot of shit, but we take care of our own.
Yeah.
We'll beat the
I'll fuck
shit
them up,
out
dude.
Of
them.
And
hey, just because we fight here doesn't mean anybody else can fuck with you.
Yeah, that's not how this
they
works.
They can go fuck. What can they do, Ansel?
I'll punch them in their face.
No,
if
no.
Wrong.
What can they do?
Fucking get hit.
No.
What's your catchphrase?
Well, what do you know?
Oh, they can
do?
Suck me I off.
They can
funny.
Suck him up.
We're not talking about carpentry and building houses.
I know a little bit of Arduino, so I know my way around electronics here and there. Like, what do you need done? That's a better question.
Why don't you take
from,
them
from
your
from plumbing to electrical to
yeah, he could be your apprentice, Phil.
No, I don't have time to teach anybody if they don't know what they're doing.
He'll just watch
so
you while you
like
do
that.
The job, and he'll learn from absorbing
so
from the.
So, are there people? Applying, they're just not qualified.
So probably can't pass
no,
a
it's
drug test.
There's people. There's nobody that's applying.
Well, and nobody's
the
applying.
The background check is everything from the FBI to
life scan
to you know.
Life you just got to not smoke weed.
That's
not,
fine. I haven't put money into weed for like 2 months now.
No math either.
Well, we all give him weed, so
I know.
We all give him the skunk weed, and he just gladly takes it.
Yep.
Yeah, he's smoked a lot of hobo weed back at Regency.
Show us pictures of the guys talking shit.
Yeah. Salvia, no
nobody's
salvia
talking
either.
Shit.
If they are,
I can take care of myself. Don't worry about
show us pictures.
Me.
They can suck Ansel off.
Naked yeah. pictures.
Yeah. Show them pictures and then send a picture
when
to
I say,
them.
When I say we'll fuck them up, I'm not including him.
Yeah. No. Yeah, I'll record it. I'll be there. I'll be there. Go, yeah.
We'll
get
keep him at a safe distance.
You'll be in the car with the motor running.
Ooh, I am a good driver.
There you go. You're the getaway.
That is true.
Yeah.
And he's unassuming, too. Like,
the security
would never think that he's about to
yeah,
do
I'll go,
a
hey, mister.
Game.
You ever seen that Clint Eastwood movie, The Mule? Mm-hmm. It'll be like that.
Hiya, mister.
Hey, mister. Oh, these fellas, I just
no,
picked them up from
Grant
Home Depot.
So what ended up happening over there at, when you encountered the cops at Scary Dairy?
I had to roll off of this guy because I have a whole story about that. We were filming. They can't do anything about that. Okay, cool. And then he starts weaving this crazy ass story. Yeah, I forgot too. You can go back to the Scary Dairy episode
check
of the Fun
tapes.
Fridays, and we'll explain the whole story there. But it was this guy's fault over here.
Yeah,
you guys went over there again.
No.
There's nothing there.
We actually didn't go over there.
We
went to the gate, and that was about it. Mm.
All right. How was your week?
It was good. Not bad. We wanted to talk about it.
Can we talk about that video I sent you? Did you see that video?
What one?
The one where that obese girl thinks she has anorexic.
The louder with Crowder?
Yeah.
I saw it, but I didn't see it.
So I'm on the fence about this because I went on a fucking. I want to talk to America right now. In America, we have a serious problem with mental illness.
Oh yeah.
In this country. When an obese woman, what do you think? She's like 300 pounds? 400 pounds?
About 400.
400 pounds?
That's pretty big, dog. Are you sure?
She's a big one. She's a big one. She goes on a talk show and she talks about how she's anorexic, but yet she's 400 pounds. Now, I looked this up. It's not an it's a mental disorder. But
what, anorexia?
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a mental disorder. It's not an eating disorder. Well, it's a mental disorder.
It's, yeah, okay.
So she needs mental help. But everyone on this damn talk show is like, oh my God, poor you. Like, you know.
And that's what she's looking for.
Yeah, and that's front the part that she's like this. She's people, and I'm not going to mention people's names, but she's like people that we used to have on the show who create this narrative and boost their shit. I don't know what's wrong with the mic.
You're talking off.
It's real directional right here.
It's a directional thing?
Right here.
Okay, all right.
Shotgun.
So there's people that push this narrative to boost this fucking thing. And she's like and the thing is crazy. She's already a model. And I don't know if her likes went down or her followers went down, but she goes on this talk show with this colored woman. And she's pushing this narrative about
Hold on. Can I interrupt you for a second?
Sure. Colored?
Why is that important?
Did you just say colored woman?
Yeah, black girl.
Why is that important?
Living in a very PC society. What do you want to call these?
Dude, like, just say black, man. Fuck. What the fuck is the problem here?
Who knows?
Is that important to the story?
It is.
Okay. Go ahead.
It is because it's all about being inclusive now. It's all about freaking coddling these people's fucking mental disorders when it's not a fucking physical. It's a mental disorder this woman has, thinking she's 400 pounds and now she has anorexia.
So do you think that she deserves help?
Yes. Okay. Mentally, she needs help.
I was just curious.
But that's not the point I'm saying.
She needs help, not coddling.
Thank you.
Okay, so I get where you're coming
from. And not only that, but she's pushing this narrative. Why do you go on a talk show and talk about this? Like, for the simple fact, do you want to boost your likes and boost your, like, sympathy? Because we've had people coming on the show pushing narratives of this, I don't know, figuratively fucking fantasy world about
the professional victim.
And the professional victim. Yeah. Thank you very much.
I wonder who you could be talking about.
But if you think about this, if there is how come it works in reverse? Like if somebody.
You think a guy?
No, no. If somebody is anorexic and they're super skinny and like, oh my God, they need help.
No.
But when someone's super morbidly obese, no one goes, oh my God, we need to help them.
Yeah.
That's not what happens.
No.
It's one way.
Yeah. And that's what pissed me the fuck off. I was thinking, what the fuck is... I was already worked up with fucking the secretary. I was worked up with fucking Kamala Harris laughing off fucking refugee questions. And then saw on the internet fucking fat, obese people saying they're anorexic. What kind of fucking world are we living in? This is fucking insane, America. I'm talking to you fucking red and blue people. This is fucking nuts.
Well, the people that listen to our show, we are real fucking... tough people. This is alpha shit right here.
Well, I don't know about that side of the room, but
hi.
What is that?
Hi.
Listen, you're part of my pack, dude.
Hey,
gay.
We'll whip you into shape. Oh,
if Chris showed me a video one time,
yeah,
that there is the alpha is in the back,
yeah,
and the strongest is in the front, and the weakest is behind the alpha of the wolf pack.
Is behind the alpha,
right? Because they're about to die and they're gonna. Is that what you said?
They're in the middle. The strongest is the front. The alpha's in the back. The weaklings are in the middle.
Who's falling way behind?
The alpha.
No, no. You said there's somebody else. The one that's about to die.
Oh, well, those are fine.
The drug addict?
Yeah, the Isaac.
Oh.
maybe 2 years ago.
I'll be the back. Isaac can be in the front.
No, Isaac was.
Remember when we went hiking? You put me in front.
Because I was in the back.
Yeah, because I was in the front leading the charge. Because I'm the strongest.
And I was in the back.
Yeah. And then everyone else was in the middle. And then this guy left.
A human centipede order?
I'm confused.
You would be confused.
Ansel left. Oh, is this the ICP?
No, Ansel was with us.
Yeah, but then he left. Remember? I went with you guys to find you.
Obviously the Sigma.
Sure. That sounds about right.
Don't know that word.
But
it's the lone wolf.
Yeah. He's no. He's more of the wolf that's about to die.
that bad, huh?
Well, you just said you didn't know how long you were living till, so
it was on you.
Yeah,
but I didn't say it on the air though. So
Phil's in the middle. We're taking care of him.
Yeah,
you.
You just kind of like I just.
I thought Phil
off.
Didn't
it's
even
fine.
Go on that one.
No, Phil was there.
You went there.
Someone will kill him soon.
He kept on bitching about okay. I don't even know why where's Stefan not telling us and stuff. He got
really
you
mad were mad.
Oh, yeah. That's
you're
right.
Mad at
that's right.
Yeah,
it's been a while since I've seen that joke.
Somebody who
fun Friday videos,
been
watch him.
Someplace 100 times, always partying and shit, can't find where he's been. He couldn't have been that stoned. He had to have gotten there while he was hot.
Why would he keep us going when we're all
well, no,
over
his,
the mountain?
His,
I have no idea.
His defense was he was trying to show us the side routes of everything. Like,
no, the grand tour.
Like he was giving us the nickel
was,
tour.
Where we were looking was nowhere near where the place was.
Nowhere near.
Well, the funny is that after we're all done, like we didn't even go back to that place. Like say, oh well, fuck it, we didn't get to that place. Let's go to the actual place we were supposed to go. And we never got there. So I don't know. I mean, I don't want to throw him under the bus.
He broke the trail going because we could have went around that way.
I mean, we had Indiana Jones over here, so I don't know.
All right. So all I know is. We are going to come back with our Fun Fridays. I believe they will probably start. The last show for Red Light would be. Hold on. I need to translate the dates. So we said April 8th would be the last recording date. So that would be that's the 15th.
Yeah.
April 15th. And then we'll probably start Fun Fridays in May. Whatever you want. Jeff is in charge of it. Jeff,
yeah.
You're in charge, okay?
Cool. Sounds good.
All right. Sean, I know. Fuck. You're going to piss me the fuck off. You're getting me in the wrong mood. You dressed in all cheap clothing today.
I thought you were just going to
you have
over
a fake, him. A fake. No, no. I'm going to slap the shit out of him if he gives me the wrong answers. You think I'm fucking playing? Look at me in the eyes.
I know you're
look
not playing.
I'm going
I,
to
I
slap him.
You.
I guarantee you,
hey,
slapping
the
shit out
right
of him.
Answers.
I'm going to knock his glasses off. Why
I'm
does
not
he have, well,
you.
Why
if
does
he
have sunglasses
I'm not
on?
Help you.
All right.
I just want you to
Sean.
I like you, but I'm not going to help you.
You owe me about $5,000, right?
You
let's just say $4,500.
$4,500.
I'll take the $3,000 off or $300 off.
$3,000.
$300. Because I think it's like 48. I think it's like $4,800. You don't show up. You don't answer. You don't go to meetings. You don't answer texts for 2 weeks, maybe three.
Correct.
You just show up here. You be weird.
I'm not being weird.
Oh
you're
yeah, you're dressed weird.
Weird. You're dressed very weird.
This is you all have like, okay. This is all I can put on.
You only
I
can put on cheap clothes?
Used to golf in a
I can't
pair
put
of pants
a t-shirt
like
on. I have to use a button-up shirt.
But you have like a billion Hawaiian shirts. Why do you have to use that one?
This is a good Hawaiian shirt.
Not with those pants.
Dude, I don't give a fuck about fashion right now. All right? I'm just wearing what's comfortable.
That's clear.
So your
clear.
Neck and your hand is hurting.
Yes.
Were you delivering packages?
I was pushed on a flight of
what
stairs.
What else hurts?
Wait,
everything fucking hurts right now, dude.
I'm going to ask you one question.
Hurt? What?
Where's the money that you owe me?
I was working on getting it.
Is that a slap in the face?
What?
Dude, I'm joking?
Yes, I think this is a comedy show.
In fact, you know.
No, I'm very eared. This is a comedy show, but shoot style,
show.
You spent about $3,000 on my credit, or $2,500 on my credit card.
We went over those numbers, yes. No, I only spent like a small amount on your credit card.
Yeah, $2,000.
No, I didn't spend nearly that much.
Yeah, it was.
Well, how did we get up to $4,500 then?
Because
you
lost
rock,
shame.
Paper, scissors in me, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You're a gambler. Lost.
Okay, so what?
Yo, again,
so,
it's not your money.
So
yeah,
where,
so
if you're gone for 2 weeks, you don't contribute for 2 weeks, where's the money?
I was getting it, all right?
This is drug addict stories right now.
So hold on, wait. You were on
you
your way.
Hear
so
my
hold
story
on, hold
or
on.
Not?
You were like, on your way to get the money, and someone pushed you down the stairs.
No, because
I don't know.
The people. All right.
All right.
The people I'm getting the money from. I still owed them some money from another time.
You
what
ran
are you
up
talking
someone
about?
Else's credit card.
A different credit card?
No, it wasn't a credit card. It was just money that I borrowed from some people.
Oh, shit.
A loan shark.
A loan shark. Okay. Or a guy that fucked you up.
I don't think that's a
yeah,
shark.
Yeah, pretty much. And so I didn't have the money, and I forgot that I owed him the money. And
wait, what?
You ended up going for a ride down the stairs.
I got dealt with. So
you still have to owe him the money?
Yes, I still owe. Well, that, I mean, I sold my car, so I still only owe him $800 now.
But where's my money?
I was working on it. All right, I mean.
You're not really working on it. So you didn't have a ride because you didn't have a car.
For 2 weeks, I couldn't have picked you up?
So wait, he sold his car and didn't give you any of the money?
No.
Fucking A, dude.
I had to give the money to the fucking.
Oh, don't be like that. Whatever you call him, a loan shark. You owe him that money now.
So I'm working on it, okay?
So then why didn't you tell me to pick you up?
Dude, I don't know. I've been in the fucking hospital for a week and a half, and I just got out yesterday, so I didn't think of these things.
Why were you in the hospital for?
Because I got pushed on a fucking flight of stairs.
Yeah, he
retard.
Got thrown down the stairs because he didn't give the dude the money that he was.
What was wrong with you?
Right, I'm going to ask you one more time. I don't give a fuck about anything. Where's my money?
I'll give you. All right, here. I'll give you what's in my wallet right now.
No, we want something of value.
Here. And then there will be more coming.
Library
this
card?
Is not even fucking.
What is that shit? What is that?
It's money. Dude, get the fuck. Give me my wallet back.
My wallet now.
Give me. No. Stand up.
Fuck. Dude, what are you fucking doing? Touch my dick.
No, this is a real wallet.
Where is the keys? Why do you have keys?
You're all night. Hey.
What?
Look at me.
What?
The money's gonna be there next week. Okay?
Violent, so violent.
Look at his eyes. Look into
the money's gonna be there next week.
Look into his eyes. Why is he covering his eyes? He's lying to you. Why is he lying to you?
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
You're not going to give me fucking Monopoly money
it's,
and then act like it's fucking real money.
It's fucking euros, dude.
That's a euro. It's worth more than regular money.
What am I going to do?
They ain't going to take it at Burger King.
Take it to the bank to say how
much. What is a euro, dude?
How much?
20. That's.
Are you
here, and
fucking
fuck
kidding
off
me,
with the $5.
That's like,
fuck off with the 20 euros.
So 45 bucks?
Fucking euros.
No, all I'm saying, Sean, is next week you're going to have money.
I'm not probably going to be here next week if you're going to keep doing that shit.
Oh, another rough up?
Dude, yeah, no, yeah. No.
Lay down the law.
No.
Lay down the law. Yeah.
Hold on. Give me this.
Give me this. You getting fresh? Are you getting fresh?
Oh, man.
Fresh?
I'm asking you questions. Are you getting fresh?
What an abusive relationship.
Are you going to be here next week?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, you are, right? You understand?
Okay. Okay, I have a plan.
So toxic.
I have a plan.
So toxic.
You're not gonna get roughed up by a different Italian people and expect to get a pass by another Italian person. I'll tell you that right now. I'll break your fucking hand.
I love how your neck is just suddenly healed.
I wouldn't even care. All he had to do is really, hey, I can't do it. Whatever. We'll pay it back. Just make sure. Let's make monthly payments on it. Whatever.
I just
tried
to give you a monthly payment.
Otherwise. $25?
Euro.
20 euros and $5.
There you go.
Was that like $40?
Yeah.
Yeah,
is that about $40?
We don't take Eddies over here,
40,
man. Just USD.
40 some odd.
No, 20, a euro, 20 euros is probably about $30, maybe less than that.
I think
so
right.
35
I think
bucks.
$35.
All right, so you're going to sit here, Sean, honestly, you're going to sit here and give me a fucking euros and say that's a down payment for something? Get
that's
the fuck out of here.
In my wallet.
Plus the wallet.
You knew you were coming today.
Yes. All right, but I have a plan.
You
I have a
didn't
plan.
Even
I have a plan. I did my taxes, and I'll get a rebate back from the government.
Why are you the only person who calls it a rebate?
Is it a rebate something you get from like a store?
Yeah.
I don't.
You can have
that's
your
like
wallet
when they
back.
Give you store credit only.
I don't listen. I don't like fucking excuses. I don't fucking play that shit.
I will have your money, sir.
I'm not even trying to be that guy. You're making me into that guy, but you're fucking treating me like an asshole.
You're kind of trying,
bro.
It's only
a dollar more now. The euro just went super down. Like I'm just looking at a 10 euros is you could get that. You get a dollar extra.
So it's $40.
$11.
So that's $22.
$22.
$11 equals $10 euros.
So $22.
Yeah.
It used to be a lot more.
It used to be a lot more.
$27.
Yeah. A lot more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Blame fucking.
I'm not trying to be that guy.
No, you gotta lay it on the wall sometimes.
But if he's gonna try to play me with $5 and a fucking $20 euro,
you can't let it slide, man.
No, that's why I fucking got it put in.
You gotta sometimes you gotta swing it around and let him know that hey,
you gotta swing that dick
your
around.
Your money's important too.
Like this guy, and if you, me and you guys are cool with this, like okay,
you all,
I'm cool with the idea of it.
I'm good with the idea. Is there another? Is there a different scenario?
You're gonna be all right. You're gonna live.
Is there a different scenario where he could have just came to me and say, "Hey, listen, this is what happened. I'm sorry." Privately, off air.
Yeah.
I wouldn't care.
Not ghosting for 2 weeks.
I feel you.
But if you're just going to leave for 2 weeks and then come at me with fucking $27?
It's a problem. Well, you gotta send somebody to relay their message, baby.
You're holding your head pretty high.
Yeah, I slapped the shit out of you, and you didn't seem like you were hurting. Maybe your hands hurt, because I did feel you like sort of shiver.
Your neck was perfectly fine.
What kind of stairs did you get thrown down? How many steps?
I didn't count them. There was too
many. It's bullshit. Why are you guys feeding in? That's like when drug addicts say like, "Oh, the last time I got high was like 2 weeks ago."
Oh, I don't do that anymore.
Did you have pink? Why does he have sunglasses on? Is what I don't understand.
Just leave me alone, dude. All right, I don't want to talk about this. I'm done. With
Jeff
this.
Wears sunglasses. I'm gonna be.
Well, he doesn't have them on now. Yeah. So out of this whole
it's only on for special moments.
Don't take off the sunglasses, please, because I know it's just another layer of bullshit, and we'll get that much upset.
Take it off.
You better not.
Take it off.
If you don't want me
take
to
it
get
off.
Upset, you better tell him not to.
Yeah, he'll give you a reason to wear some sunglasses.
Take it
he
off.
He has Ray-Bans on, so you can't pawn those Ray-Bans to give him money for it. When did you get Ray-Bans? I didn't know you had Ray-Bans. When did he buy Ray-Bans?
Hey. Leave my watch. That my grandfather gave me. Grandfather gave me that watch.
Take his glasses. His Ray-Bans. Ray-Bans.
When I give you the check next week, you'll give me the watch.
Maybe. I don't know.
No, maybe.
His grandfather stuck it up his asshole.
Oh, that one. Yeah, 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 that one.
And the watch.
That's my wedding ring.
Just like Christopher
I can't
Walken.
Get it off my finger.
Get his glasses.
You better get some butter.
Get those. That's at least $100 glasses right there.
No, they're all scratched up.
You can pawn them off. $75. It's more than the $30 that he tried to give you with the euros.
I could get you
or $22.
Only
30. Maybe.
It's a $700 watch.
Hey, burnt my fingers, man.
Yeah. Maybe 50.
Chris, how much do you think you could get that watch?
How much can I sell this one for?
There you go.
That's a $700 watch.
Hey, man, value ain't what it used to be, baby.
That shit's so hot.
This is Biden economy, bro.
Times are tough.
This is Biden economy.
Okay, so it's a $900 watch then.
No. More like a $100 watch.
Yeah.
Fuck you want from me, homeboy? I don't want the one that set the prices, but we got to make some money off that squirrel.
All right.
So that means you're the fall guy.
I'm still surprised that you thought that the glasses were going to make this outfit really good. Like, this whole...
Do you know something about the glasses?
No, this is the first time I've ever seen him wear
Ray-Bans. No. What's going to happen is he's going to take them off, and there's going to be probably something wrong with his eye. And if there's something wrong with his eye, whatever the opposite eye is, I'm going to slap the shit out of it.
Did your eye pop out?
So I'm going to tell you... I'm going to give you a chance right now.
What?
You're going to keep those glasses on the entire show, and if you take them off, I'm slapping you on the other side. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Don't call me sir either. That's fucking gay.
It is pretty gay.
I don't want to get hit anymore. I'm trying to be as respectful as I can, okay?
Well, you can do it without saying sir or other gay shit like
that. Yeah. Because all you're doing is making me look like the fucking villain.
Yeah, you're making...
You're making me look like a heel.
You're starting to piss me off.
And you're trying to babyface up the audience.
I'm not trying to
babyface. They better not even... Huh?
This is kayfabing it.
He's kayfabing.
I don't
even know. No, he's doing it on purpose. It's all work.
This is a dub sub situation.
It's like a professional...
This whole thing's a work. He's dressed like...
Fucking the Joker and
like he just
he's dressed up as the Joker.
Someone from the 1970s.
Joaquin Phoenix's Joker here. That's life.
Stop. Keep that face. That look off your face.
What is in his eye?
Take that look off your face. Thank you,
sir.
All right, this is Red Light District Show,
sir.
Who said? Did you say that?
I didn't say anything. Isaac's saying shit again. He's doing the Hollywood Isaac thing again.
Hey.
There's no Hollywood Isaac.
Let me see your smile. While I take this out. Okay. In the microphone. In the camera. This is a Red Light Show. And we'll be right back. Hey, while you're there, give us a comment. Give us a like. I know you're not going to share because we don't share it a lot. But
subscribe
if you could
for the
share
love of God.
And give us a subscribe. At least a fucking subscribe. And I would like to say, ladies and gentlemen, This is Retrospect Band.
Woo!
Thank you.
Hey, Retrospect Band, how are you guys?
Good.
Man, that was an awesome set, especially, I mean, that Long Train Running. I love that song. I haven't heard that one. Like, I'm going to add it to my playlist now because I just totally forgot about it. How long have you guys been together? Let's start with the names. Here we go.
I'm Brian.
I'm Kelly.
Rich. James.
Ed.
Robert.
All right. How long have you guys had this project going, and how did it get started?
I'm going to pass the mic back on to Robert.
We got overhead.
Oh, you got overhead? Okay, yeah. Good. All right. Robert, field this one.
Well, I mean, Retrospect as a band, we've been 3.5 years. Prior to that, myself and Ed, this band evolved from a band we were in before that called Pot Belly Stoves. And as we just kept evolving, kind of going more into rock type stuff, I mean, it turned into Retrospect. We found Kelly as our vocalist, and it's been building ever since.
Freaking A. So 3 years? I love the keys, and you don't really see a lot of keys in bands nowadays, so man, you got to keep that. We just saw a keyboardist in a metal band earlier, and I was like, man, that really gives a little edge to it, and I like it. So how long have you been singing? Just period, in general.
Since I was 4 years old.
How did you know that's something you like to, that's
It's just a passion. I'm happy when I'm singing. That's like when I'm happiest, honestly. I've known it's something my whole life. I've always wanted to do it, and I've been able to do it through my entire life pretty much in some way or another. So.
And what about you on keys?
I've actually been playing piano since I was 4 years old. I was classically trained, actually got a master's degree in piano at one point, but I was always a rocker at heart, and so grew up on bands like Yes and Emerson, Lake and Palmer, and I love a chance with this band to put it all together and pull out all the stops.
So when you start at four, were you always in a band? You got a master's in it. What are you doing when you're not playing? Is your job have to do with?
I'm actually an aerospace engineer.
Oh, no shit. I work in aerospace too.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I was in the service for 12 years.
Excellent, yeah.
Are you at Magoo?
No, I run a company. Have a company of a bunch of consultants.
Uh-huh.
We just work together and have a lot of fun.
Fucking hey, dude, that's weird. I work in aerospace. You do too. Music side hobby. Yep. Trying to make it full
keeps,
hobby.
Keeps me centered and balanced. And
yep.
I do this because I have to do it.
Yeah. Yep. That's how I am.
I think we all are.
What's up back there on the guitar? Tell us about yourself.
Sure. I've been playing guitar since I was about 13 or 14.
And oh, you have accent.
Yeah, I grew up in England. And
oh, okay, there
we have the accent.
Moved out here in my, early 20s after college. So.
Oh, you're not in 20s, okay. So you're older than in your 20s?
I've been 25 for the last 20 years.
You English guys, you guys age gracefully, huh?
It's all the beer.
It's the beer? The Guinness?
Yeah, it helps, man.
So you're back. You were from England.
Yeah, I grew up playing guitar, and wanted to do that seriously. But on the side, I was like, I might not make any money at it, so I went to engineering school, and I'm an engineer too. I'm in biotech, so that's what I do during the week. But I'm passionate to music, right? So
you're in biotech. I am too.
You're awesome.
Small world here, huh?
See, man.
I'm really in aerospace.
I was like in my early teens. I went from riding my BMX to playing along to Guns N' Roses and Metallica and Aerosmith. And
how did you get this area?
This one? For work. I moved out here in my early 20s stayed around. And I've been in Ventura County for like 20 years now.
Amgen or something?
Baxter, actually.
Baxter, okay.
Yeah, just down the road from Amgen.
Yeah,
local company. And I was there for a while and then moved to Santa Monica for a different job a few years back. But I've got a wife and kid in the area, so we've been here for a while now. And I knew Robert. 2006, we were in a blues band together, mm-hmm. right? And, we stayed in touch, and then he got together with these guys, and they were playing, and they were looking for a guitarist a couple years back, so he reached out, and we started jamming and hit it off, so I've been in here since, end of 2019, I guess. We're getting really good momentum, and then, 2020 went a bit weird.
Went off the rails.
Man, we had it all going on until
this goddamn pandemic. And we're still not fully, like, recuperated.
Yeah, it's. I feel like we're paying our dues all over again because of the fact that after everything closed down, it's reopening. It's kind of like we have to regain our fan base, but which is fine because we're kind of finding a new sound with some new people. Brian came on board just before COVID, and our bass player, Rich, has been with us for about a month. He's brand new.
We're getting to Rich right now. What's up, Rich?
What's up, man?
So what is your background?
I'm from New York originally.
Oh, yeah?
Born in Brooklyn.
Oh, there.
I've been playing since I'm 15. Kiss fan. When I saw Gene Simmons spit blood, that was it. I knew I had to play. And but you know, I moved out here when I was 21, and I played in some strip bands. Played the Whiskey and the Roxy. Did that for a number of years. Then I had to get a real job. So now I'm a I work in animation. I'm an editor.
Shut up, Isaac.
I work on cartoons for a living. So.
That's fun.
Yeah.
You're artists all around.
Yeah, we try to be, you know.
Like, what kind of cartoons?
Right now, I'm working on a Disney TV show. But the company I work for, we do so much. They do a lot. So it's, you know, I just got off one for Apple TV. Called Wolf Boy and the Everything Factory, and that's all I do, cartoons.
Have you ever, I'm not saying, and if you, just deny it if you do, because you don't want to get in trouble, but do you know of, like, other cartoonists that put, like, little hidden stuff in? Because I remember back when I was a kid, right?
Oh, yeah.
The Little Mermaid, there's fucking dicks inside the cover.
Yeah, yeah. Personally, I've never put a dick into a cartoon. Now that you mention it, you know, there probably could fit one or two in there somewhere. If I do, I will let you know.
All right, back on drums.
Well, I'm, you know, originally from California. I grew up in the South Bay area, San Pedro area. Started playing when I was 12 and joined my first band when I was 14 and was a product of the Hollywood metal scene. We probably crossed paths somewhere on the strip and didn't know it. And played in metal bands of varying forms up until it was time to get serious after college and cut my hair and get a job. And I'm a project manager for a large construction company and just didn't play for a number of years just because, you know, work, career, family, and moved around the country for a while, came back, played my first band when I got back with James back in 2006 when I moved to Thousand Oaks. Didn't play for a while until I came across Ed and some, you know, a friend from the past where we did the Potbelly Stoves. And then that evolved to here.
Hey, and it leaves us our last guy, Ed.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks like you were like a manager for one of the Fab Five. Or
no, I'm just older than everybody.
Yeah. But you do help him fly around.
Well, I've been playing since I was 9 years old and kind of grew up on the Ventures, Johnny Cash, you know, all those guys back there. And anyway, I actually had to get out of the music business a little while. I actually did do it professionally. I came out here and we played around in some of the hotels and in Las Vegas. And when that all fell apart, I got a real job too. So I've been in the insurance business since 1974. And that's what I still do. So.
Well, all right, listen. You heard of the Patrick Price, right?
Mm-hmm.
You've also heard of the Rogers Rate. I don't know who you might know in the insurance business, but you might be able to take this back to him. Have you ever heard of the Allen adjustment?
Allen adjustment. Well,
for Josh Allen, we got to get him in the game.
Yeah. Well, let me.
That's my favorite football team.
Narrow this down a little bit. I do nothing but airplanes and aerospace.
Oh, okay.
So
me too.
Oh, really? Good.
No, I really do. T-56 engines. That's my specialty.
Okay.
I'm a QA manager right now.
Awesome. Great.
Yeah,
right.
Cheers.
Yeah, you want to buy insurance?
No. It's not my money.
But anyway, as Robert said, he and I met through a mutual friend, and we've been together the longest. We're probably the founding members, I guess you could call it.
And when you were, like, growing up, or when you were, like, going hard, you're saying you were doing it professionally?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what bands were you?
Or
what type of music?
We were like lounge band type stuff. You would have never heard of us. we didn't play on the Las Vegas Strip. I don't know if you go back this far. Remember the Silver Slipper? The casino. Okay.
I'm young.
Well, they blew that up with a couple of other ones a few years back. Well, we played in a little bitty nightclub that was across the street from there. We kept reappearing there, but that's where all the acts would come, in after hours, and they'd come and watch us. So, we played in Anaheim, the Grand Hotel, when that was going. We played in the ballroom there.
That's awesome.
We were like a big horn band.
Oh, I love that. Mm-hmm. Well. What do you guys have coming up in the next 6 months?
Well, I know right now we're, since we have a new member, and we're trying to update our website, and we're going to be shooting a video hopefully very soon, so that we can put that on the website and put it on our EPK and everything else to try to help, advertise this. Because like I said, I feel like we're starting over with COVID and everything. It's kind of like we have to go back out there and hustle. Mm-hmm. Because everybody's coming out at once. So everybody's, we have that planned. We have a photo shoot planned, and then we have a couple gigs coming up. One in March, correct? Or both
March
in March?
25th.
Are they both in March?
Yeah. 25th.
The 25th. And what was the other one?
One in May.
One in May. That was the one.
I imagine we'll be back in Mrs. Olson's.
Right.
Sunland Vineyard.
Sunland is in March.
Sunland Vintage Winery in March. Mm-hmm. And,
Mrs. Olson's.
And Mrs. Olson's in Channel Islands.
Oh, in the garage, too. Are we in
the garage? Oh, yeah, in the garage.
In the garage. Yeah,
in Ventura.
In May.
Not this garage. Well.
No, I know
that. Not your garage, but in the garage. In Ventura, yeah. In May.
Guys, thank you so much for coming out. Thank you for being a part of our, our creativity and helping local music. And, man, thank you so much. Where can people find you?
You can find us on our website. It's retrospecttheband.com. Or we also have retrospecttheband.la on YouTube and Instagram. So that's where you can find us.
There you go. All right. This is No Cover Presents Red Light Disc Show, and we will be right back after this.
I'm not afraid to die.
Sean, I'm not playing.
Hey, guys.
You know what the deal is, dude.
All right, I'm going to get you your...
No, you're feeling sorry for yourself. No, I'm saying start the game.
Okay.
You're just sitting at the ground. Or staring at the... There's nothing even there.
All right.
I'm going to punch your fucking ass.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
That's not even real.
It's fucking real, dude. Can I have that back?
No. You put it on again, I'm going to slap you.
Your head's moving pretty well.
You're leaving us open to lawsuits, man.
I'm going to smash on him.
I know you are, but I mean, we're still going to live after that. So
well, I don't know. With this whole royal Russia, we might not be able to live anywhere.
Go ahead, Sean.
Okay. We're doing the license plate game. It's a simple concept. It's like when you're driving behind a car and you see and they've got a vanity plate and you're trying to figure out what the vanity plate says. So we're going to do this. We got a bunch of vanity plates. These are all real vanity plates taken from the internet and recreated. And so we're going to put one up and you guess what it is. And whoever chimes in can take a guess. If they get it, they're worth 2 points.
Okay. All
right. Everybody understand the game?
No, can you repeat that?
Yeah, we're going to look at vanity plates and try to guess.
It's a fucking license plate game, dude. Everybody's been driving down the fucking road.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'll play that game.
And you read something, you're like, you're trying to figure it out, you don't know what it is. Yeah.
All right, what's the question, Jeff?
That's all you had to say.
So, in order to guess, we are yelling our names.
Yes.
Same as always.
Is this not a team theme?
Exactly.
Okay. Is it a team theme?
No, it's
No?
Well, I mean, it could be a team. You two versus you two.
Tijuana Tiger, Typhoon Trinity coming back?
Well, that's three people, so me, us.
No, I won't be there. I'll just be working. I'll do drops.
Okay, then you two versus you two.
Is that what we're doing?
The whiteys versus the fucking colored, right?
All
right,
the Tijuana Trinity Tigers.
No, whites.
Don't you ever in your fucking life
versus,
call me
what
colored
What are you guys
again.
Called?
Fucking
brownies.
Okay. What the
brownies.
Fuck? What?
Yeah, dude, you're working on getting a whole nother ass.
You want those legs broken too?
Yeah, I mean, because if you think I'm gonna throw you down the stairs and call it good,
give yourselves
I'm
a fucking name.
Yo, shit.
The people of color. I don't know.
Sit down.
Sit down.
We gotta wait.
Sit down and play
the
game. Just sit down and play the game. All right.
Hey, he's so sorry.
All right.
I'm gonna have to teach y'all how to commit a crime.
What's our names?
We can be the Wolverines.
The Wolverines. I like that.
Wolverines.
That's such a 90s name.
Red Dawn. Love it.
And
very appropriate.
Trinity over here.
Okay.
Versus the Wolverines.
Are you guys ready to play?
I'm ready, baby.
Yes.
All right, Wolverines. Triple T, you guys ready to play?
More like a quadra T, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Can we get the first clue on the screen, please?
Is that dog stoned?
Oh. Fuck my All asshole.
Time. Jeff.
Oh, shit.
All right. Team Triple T.
Montana.
No, Issac.
Issac. Team
Wolverines.
Wolverines.
Can we see it one more time?
Yeah, put it up there one more time.
That's way too fast.
For longer than a second.
Wow.
Okay, longer than 2 seconds.
Okay, I'll take a guess at it.
All right, go ahead.
Beaver Pleaser.
Beaver Pleaser is correct.
Oh, wait. We're guessing what it... Oh, fuck. We're guessing what it says. I thought we were guessing...
He thought he was
what
the
same
thing
we were doing.
And he goes, Montana.
I was asleep. It was Montana.
I was asleep because it said Montana. I was like, oh, they're starting off easy.
You do realize, bro, we have meetings every Wednesday, right?
And that it says...
You do know that you were a part of that meeting, correct?
I told you I don't pay
attention. You do know you were a part of that meeting, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, are you, dude? Are you?
Yeah, I think so.
Are you Jeff?
Hello.
Was it the same guy that was in the meeting?
Might have been.
Did you switch?
I was probably a little more out of it then.
Did you switch automatically? Or are you?
Dude, I just watched The Matrix today. I can't answer these questions right now. All right,
go ahead. All right.
You don't think that's strange, what just happened?
I don't give a fuck. We got points, so keep doing that.
What? Who turned on the light? It's too yellow.
It's been on the whole time, I think.
No.
Unless Phil did it.
Sabotaged it before he took off.
Better?
Yeah.
Turn on the white, not the yellow.
How do we even know to do that one?
Turn off the yellow and turn on the other one.
And turn it down.
Now you're turning it blue.
Make it a soft one.
Whatever you're doing, stop fucking it up.
All right, you got the next one ready?
Yep. Next one's ready.
Okay.
All right, let's see this.
Let's see do this. Clue number two.
Let's do this.
That's me. That's Tim.
Can we get that up there?
Do it longer, man. Come on.
I know it.
Yeah, but
oh, Jeff. I know it too.
Jeff.
California. Well, he called it first.
I didn't even see the whole fucking thing.
No, no, it's it's a speciesism. You can talk.
All right. Go.
Vibrator?
What?
Vibrator?
Vibrator is correct.
I thought it was California.
I thought it was vibrator. Like raider? Like,
that's what it reads, though. Vibrator.
It's vibrator.
But I didn't think about it. Vibrator.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's get the next one queued up and ready to go.
All right.
Go ahead, Chris.
Oh, I heard something turn off over there. Is it this one? Did that one turn off?
No.
Oh. Can we pull up the clue, please?
I have it.
I know. I'm just
can
asking.
We see it? There we go.
Can we get it on the screen?
Oh, hold on. I didn't even read this one.
Wait, what? I got it, Isaac.
All right, Team Wolverines.
Can I see it one more time?
No.
No? I can't. There's no...
Jeff.
I ate one, and you ate one, too. I think that's what it was.
That is correct. I ate one, you ate one, too. Wolverines go to 4 points.
Is that what that's supposed to be?
That is exactly
I just hear all...
all right.
Oh, I know this one.
Pull up the next one, please.
Isaac.
All right, team.
Fucking pussy magnet.
Yeah. Pussy magnet is man. Correct.
Pussy magnet.
That was a Texas plate too. Like, yeah.
All right, next clue.
Isaac.
Yeah.
Fill her up.
Yep.
That is incorrect.
Oh,
Jeff.
What?
Jeff.
Fill up.
What the hell is wrong with you?
That is also incorrect.
Duff.
Well, I mean, sure, go ahead. Any points. I mean, that's already
is
done.
It feel you up?
Fill you up is correct.
All right, Durf gets a point.
All
right. Oh, yeah.
Durf is playing by himself. Perfect.
Yep.
Wow.
All right, next clue, please.
Breaking the team up.
Isaac. You want to answer? I know you know it. Say it.
Go ahead.
No, say it.
Go ahead, Team Wolverines.
Alabama. All right. Do it.
Two in the pink.
Two in the pink and one in the pink.
Oh, shit.
It's just two in the pink, but good enough. All right.
With the extra mile.
Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Next clue, please.
What? Oh, Durf. Isaac.
Durf.
All right, Team Triple T.
Okay, so it's no fucks given.
That is correct. All right.
How'd they get this shit first? Wolverine's
what's
fat,
the score right now, Sean?
Because
right now we are Wolverines. At 8. For the Wolverines and 6 for Tijuana Teaser Tigers.
Wolverines?
Tijuana Tiger Typhoon Trinity.
Wolverines?
They have 8.
Wolverines?
And they have 6?
And they have 6.
How did they get 6?
How'd they get 8?
Because they answered 4 of them correctly.
Wolverines?
They got 3?
I don't know.
And they got 3?
Oh, okay. All right. I don't know. All right.
Math sucks.
I don't know what this one is.
Numbers.
Numbers.
Go ahead and pull that up, Chris.
Oh, I think I know what this is.
Keep put it up and leave it up, please. Anybody want to chime in? Any team?
See my X for BJ. Wolverines.
Wolverines. Go ahead, please.
See my ex for BJ.
That is correct.
Okay, then.
Sometimes you just got to talk those ones out.
At all. He was just saying the whole thing, and I still couldn't get it.
This is 100% me.
All right. Next one, please. That is 100% you.
Durf. Isaac.
The Durf.
Durf.
It's masturbates.
It is masturbates. For sure.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I said it was me. Oh, my God. I don't know this.
Is that dog stoned? Always.
Ooh. All right. We got a tough one coming up here. Let's go ahead and put it up on the screen.
Ooh. Isaac.
All right. Team Wolverines.
Butt sex?
Butt sex is correct.
Butt sex. I know. Read.
I didn't even know that.
I know butt sex when I see it.
All right.
That's right.
Chris, let's put this next clue on the screen.
Isaac.
Yep.
All right. Team Wolverines.
Oh.
Eight, I know it is. Ate her out?
Ate her out is correct.
Yes. Fucking yes.
How come you didn't know that, Durf?
All right. Tijuana Teenage He's Tigers, you guys are lacking.
By
you
2 points, right?
Like about 2 points.
No, I think it's a little more than 2 points.
8 points. The Wolverines have 14 points.
Fucking
eight. But there's still plenty of time to catch up.
Yeah, come on, guys.
Wolverines? My cogs are processing.
Who keeps
what the hell is going on? Come on, how do you not know this?
I'm thinking
it's not up there yet.
I know that, Tim.
I know it's you,
yeah,
Tim.
Yeah, yeah, look.
Isaac.
Pat.
Ass. Oh.
I'm going to go with the Tijuana Teenage Tigers.
Wait, what?
It's no. Ass orgy.
Well, you got
ass
Chris
orgy.
You got the answer over there. Oh, so.
No, come on. Nobody's whispering nothing. Is that what he was saying? I had no idea. Whoa, first of all,
I didn't
he's
even hear
saying it. Loud enough everyone can hear it, and I still couldn't hear what he was saying.
Either way, point given.
This is how we're okay.
That's how we're playing it. All right, Chris wants to fuck it up for you guys.
You know, this is your downfall right here, Sean. Yeah. This is your downfall.
Sean already had a downfall last week.
It was down the stairs.
Yeah, down the stairs, man. His downfall already happened.
Isaac.
Oh, Jeff.
All right, Team Wolverines.
Put it back up there. I didn't even see it. She said gay sex.
Of course it's gay sex.
Oh, yeah.
Isaac knows gay sex.
I definitely know. It's from Oregon. Gay sex from Oregon is fucking 100%. Speaking of gay sex.
All right, next one.
Isaac.
Go ahead, Team Wolverines.
Oh, okay.
Huh?
Dick extension?
Dick extension is correct.
Russian dick pills.
Oh, no.
Can't get those anymore.
Just guess I don't know nothing about that. I know nothing about the dick extension.
All right, so we have an obvious tactic
Dad,
here.
You know it.
Team Wolverines is just chiming in and hoping they get it. We're going to go ahead and put a 5-second cap on it.
Hail Mary.
So if you do not know the answer and you get it within...
Isaac.
And you don't get it within five
Isaac.
Seconds, then you
Isaac.
Lose points. Go ahead, Isaac.
Dick. Penis. Cock.
That, yeah, that is pretty much just a cock across the Florida page. So.
Are you talking about the orange bit or the green bit?
No, it's just a dickhead.
Yes.
That's a dickhead.
I know a cock when I see one.
And the zeros are the penis itself,
yeah,
and then the eight is
the
balls.
That's the shaft. No, the zeros
correct.
Are the shaft.
The zeros
are
the shaft.
Yeah, yeah.
And the D is the head, and the eights are the two balls.
And the Florida is the weird growth from that one girl.
It's the herpes.
So it's two penises.
The penis of the United
yeah,
States.
That's good, Durf.
Thank you.
I didn't even know that
I
one.
I didn't need no 5 seconds
right.
on that one.
Next clue, please, Chris.
Wait. Durf.
All right. Team Durf.
I would like to say it's Turd Pusher.
Turd Pusher is correct.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. It is Turd Pusher. It is Turd Pusher.
All right. Next clue, please,
Chris. It was funny
because
it was Hawaii.
Chris.
Come on, guys. It's right. It's so.
Oh, Jeff. Jeff.
Isaac. Isaac.
Isaac
got all the way to fuck your bitch.
Yeah. Oh, way yeah. to fuck your bitch is correct.
Smiling
you know
faces.
That, yes,
faces.
I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Next clue.
Oh, Jeff.
Jeff, go ahead.
Huge dick.
Huge
oh,
dick.
Oh, yeah.
is correct.
He knows
right.
a huge dick.
We are nearing
one.
The end here.
Durf.
All right, Durf, go ahead.
Fuck me right now.
That is incorrect.
What?
Minus 2 points.
Wait, we're subtracting points for getting it wrong now?
Yes.
What?
Was that at the beginning of the game?
No, I did just announce that a few minutes ago.
I don't remember that.
No.
Okay.
You didn't pay attention at the meeting? You didn't pay attention here?
Yeah.
You weren't even
at
the meeting.
At the meeting.
We got it.
You weren't even at the
Team
meeting.
Wolverines.
Fuck me running?
Fuck me running.
Yeah.
Oh, it's fuck me running.
Yes.
Start running.
Okay.
I like how that's where Forrest Gump was running.
All right, this one's a little trickier. Go ahead and cue it up, please. You may have to stand on your head to get this one right.
Oh,
Yeah, asshole.
Oh.
Wolverines.
Wolverines, go ahead.
Asshole.
Asshole is correct.
That's a good one.
That is a good one.
Okay, then.
All right. Can we let Durf answer this one?
Sure.
Okay. Durf.
All right. Go ahead and pull it up. Durf.
Is it Pat is gay?
Durf, we already said we're not talking about Pat like that.
I mean, he has his hand up my ass right now. That's pretty gay.
You know what
Pat says.
You know what? It was actually, go ahead and pull it up again. It was actually Pat is sexy.
Oh.
But we'll give it to you for Pat is gay for 2 points.
You ruined it, Durf. It's Pat is sexy.
Oh. I saw. I don't see him like
Isaac.
That. Durf gives no fucks.
Jeff. I heard Jeff chime in on this one.
Yes, Jeff. Go ahead, Jeff.
Pull it back up, please.
Says, fuck you too, Jeff.
All right, fuck you
and
too, Jeff.
Fuck you, Sean. My fog machine's better.
All right.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Oh, my God. Pat is sexy. Asshole. Fuck me running.
All right, so we had Wolverines with 26.
Put it on there, and I'm just going to read them over again.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles with 16. So congratulations.
Yeah.
Woo! Wolverines! Wait, what were the points again? 18 and 16?
26 Wolverines? And 16.
Oh, 26 and 16. Yes. Okay. I'm not paying attention.
All right, so this just one's like the fuck you too, Jeff. Yeah. Pat is sexy. Asshole. Fuck me running. Huge dick.
Tim.
On my way to... What? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
On my way to fuck your bitch. Oh, no point of that. I'll just put it in there. Definitely cutting this. Go ahead.
Yeah, this needs to be cut. All
right. Is it there? All right. Fuck you too, Jeff. Pat sexy. Asshole. Fuck me running. Huge dick. On my way to fuck yo bitch. Turd pusher. A penis. Hold on. See, this right here is the actual penis. The shaft. This is the head. And this is the balls.
Anatomy with Tim.
Dick. Extension. Gay sex. Ass. Orgy. Ater out.
Butt sex.
Sex. Masturbates? No, probably. I don't know. Are they real, Sean?
They are all pulled from the internet, so they have to be
PJ,
real.
No fucks given. Two in the pink.
Philip. Fill you up.
Fill you up.
Pussy magnet. I eat one, you eat two. Okay. Vibrator. And beaver pleaser.
Montana. Good old Montana.
I can't believe you got that.
Montana.
I can't believe you got that all jacked up, Jeff.
I got the state right, though.
Montana.
Montana.
Yeah, it's kind of hard not to get it right when it's on the screen.
Oh, look, it's Steve Perry.
Yeah.
What's going on there?
It's Steve Perry.
Are we trying to get demonetized here? What's going on?
Well, no, you only saw him, first of all. There's nothing wrong with seeing Steve Perry.
Okay, hello?
All right, there you go.
Hello. Hello.
There's nothing wrong with seeing Steve Perry.
Oh.
It happens to millions of Americans every year.
Yeah, she ended up, Suzanne ended up writing me.
Did you really sponsor her?
Yeah. I don't know what to tell her. I mean, the truth is.
You told her what I thought you were going to tell her.
No, I just said we got to talk later.
Oh.
The truth is there's somebody on the show that don't like you. They don't want you to come back.
Like, legitimately, like, does not like.
Oh, I know.
Like with a like, was probably gonna walk out of the show if you brought her back.
Oh, probably.
Like I wouldn't put it past that situation happening.
I don't understand. I honestly like the chaos that Suzanne brings.
I do too.
I think it's great.
I don't mind.
I miss being
in
able
moderation.
To stand tits.
I don't mind it in moderation. Like every week, maybe not. Maybe every other week or every week when we probably need her. Yeah, but not. I don't know about every week. Because we do need a break from that. Because you, there's not, I agree with you 100%.
Maybe
I like,
once a month.
But then wait, who was it that, oh, never mind. I know who it is now.
Listen, I mean, should we just have her on next week?
Yes.
Ah, fuck it.
Not next week.
Since we're not here.
Oh, yeah,
next
we're
week,
not.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's bring her on next week.
Oh.
Oh.
I think it would be fun to have her back for, I mean, at least an episode. Have her visit with us or whatever.
Yeah, I think that's okay.
Let's do it.
Are you trying to get people mad at me or what?
No, I think he wants the attention off him.
I just like the chaos.
I think he wants a day off.
Like, I am, like, so addicted to that chaos.
Yeah.
That's
what, like, no one was getting. I was loving it.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. I think it needs to be in moderation. It's because too much sparkle is, oh.
But the thing is, like, he couldn't even give me, the only reason he gave me he don't like her is because she bothers him.
What the fuck is that? What the fuck are you supposed to do with
but
that?
Yeah, but Pam bothered him, and he didn't fuck. He took it to the fucking lip.
I think females in general bother
I think so, too.
I think Pam wanted to fuck him.
Who, Dennis?
Yeah.
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 He was actually repulsed by it.
Yeah.
Not that there's anything wrong with Pam.
I'm kind of jealous now.
I'm going to say I like Suzanne a little better than Pam.
Okay, but
I definitely like her. I like her a lot better than Pam.
Yeah, I can agree.
Anyone's was better than Adrian, so...
That girl role's been a revolving door, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Adrian one, that one just took forever to get rid of her. Like, how come he didn't say nothing about Adrian?
Because I think he liked the I was flustered. I was getting flustered with it.
It just doesn't make sense. Well, no, like, he was okay with Adrian, but he's not okay with Suzanne.
Because he has a problem with girls.
No, I don't think that's true.
I think he does, too. But what does that mean, though?
That he wasn't threatened by her because she's not
gay?
In the market, so to speak.
Wait, because she was gay?
Yeah.
She worked at a mortuary, right?
Off. You don't have to.
Well, no, worry but I mean, I don't.
You know. Think he's intimidated by her?
Who, Suzette?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
I think she's maybe. Loud, yeah, and demanding, and like saying like.
Maybe that's.
I think that's what it was. Loud. Maybe that's what it is, and he doesn't like that because. Again, but then again, maybe it rubbed in the wrong way, thinking, like, you're brand new. How are you going to be demanding on this stuff? Maybe he took it that perspective. Like,
but that is the, for me, that's the.
That's what guts
that's
your noodle.
That's good.
That's what bakes your noodle.
Yeah,
that was the annoying for me, though.
But that, or think about it. What kind of sane person comes in here demanding?
Right, when you don't even know how the show works.
Exactly. What kind of sane person does that?
No, you have to be insane.
That is fucking insane and crazy.
It's fucking nuts.
Insane.
I loved it. I'm so glad me and you are seeing eye to eye.
You're hired.
No.
I feel so like
I'm not saying it's bad. I never said it was bad.
Oh, I did. I said it was bad.
I said it's good in moderation. I agree with you. I'm saying the chaos works. You have to have some kind of control chaos, but you can't have it every... Because it will drain all of us. And I think it will drain Dennis more than anybody.
Drain
I mean, or this edit that out. That person that's, you know, doesn't like that person.
Yeah, especially in the first 30 minutes of the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was also going to, since we're editing this part out, may I say anything?
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, like, he's not going to be here for the next couple of weeks anyways until the end of the season. So what would it hurt?
Yeah, say whatever you want to. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, that's
right?
that's not fact. That's
a fact right there.
Yeah. Not like we're recording it or anything.
Do you think you're going to get, like, a handjob offer or something?
I mean, I could try.
Right.
No, get a blowjob, because supposedly she gives the best ones, remember?
Can I film it?
Literally, like...
I'll let you use my new camera.
Literally, like, 2 weeks after when she came in, she was talking
so
about
so weird. We are weird people.
Well, no.
So what?
Who is the kind of person that introduced him to a bunch of strangers, a bunch of men, and then, like, the second week you tell them, oh, by the way, I'm, like, really good at blowjobs.
That's somebody who wants to
get
blowjobs.
Oh, you're talking about her and us?
Yeah.
That's sort of weird, referring to us as just a bunch of men.
Yeah.
That's pretty much where we are, though.
But also the first week, she said we all had 4-inch dicks.
And then
she has no proof, though.
She didn't even see my dick, and she already knew I had a 4-inch dick. That was
no, she just
so
wants
weird.
You to,
it's that X-ray vision.
Nah, I'm not going to do that. You can suck me off. But not really.
Yeah. Hey, she's probably down.
Maybe that's the broken girl you need, dude.
Oh, my God.
Can we set that up?
Oh, my God.
Can we set up Suzanne and fucking Ansel, the love machine maker?
Bring your rope next week.
Yeah, dude. Oh, dude, she probably is some kinky-ass shit, bro.
You guys are crazy.
Nah, dude, she's crazy.
Journey of celibacy.
Yo, that crazy shit. Okay, hold on.
Okay, yeah.
That crazy shit you talking about, that's fucking
her. That's her.
Shine and sparkle.
100% that's her.
Dude.
She's damaged like a motherfucker.
Oh, instead of setting Pat up on a date, that's the date. Ansel and Suzanne.
Yeah.
That, it really
that's,
is.
That's, I can see that happening.
Hey, can we see that for a fucking
and she
Friday?
Got some big ass titties.
Yeah. Just like
he's trying to
shaky cam and everything.
Am I, okay,
have you met her
from
yet?
The window?
This got hard at work. We met once. We didn't talk. But
was she on the show?
She had the thing in her eye and she couldn't see
it. Oh. That was her last day.
Yeah, the last time.
There was something weird that happened. It's sort of like, well, one, she took an hour and a half on a bit that I didn't like, and she kept on blaming me for it. I don't like that shit.
I blame me for it.
No, it's not. It's her.
Well, 100% not your fault. You got fucked on that.
I wish I got fucked up.
You're going to. Believe me.
By men?
Well, hopefully we'll have a threesome. You, because I know, like, oh, we're trying to hook him up now because she's like that. But also, we can't forget about this.
Are we
guy's
just
going to
run a train? Like,
No. I'm not in on this.
No, sir.
So it's just going to be Sean.
No, not me.
So Sean, Ansel, and Jeff.
No.
I mean, and Durf.
No.
And, yeah, I guess it's a train.
Yeah.
Not me, though.
Choo choo. What are we doing?
I mean, I'll record it.
No, I guess it's just you two.
I'll record it. What are we doing now?
We're going to have a threesome. You and
the
her.
Three-way.
A foursome if you add dirt.
All right, so she's going to come. We're going to bring her on the show.
She's going to come.
Oh, she's coming.
Oh, she's going to come.
More than once.
I'll bring her on. We'll have her on the show. We'll just try to do it until Dennis doesn't know. We won't put her in the thumbnail.
How are we going to?
Don't you think that they would be a good match? I think that would be a good match for them. I think that's a good match.
What? We're just not going to tell Dennis.
The secret Susan show.
No, I'm being completely honest. I think her, him, and Susan would be a good match together.
Yeah, I do.
Like, for real.
We'll hook them up. We talked about it. Yeah, we'll hook them up.
Because she's the perfect kind of crazy for you. And that's the shit you're looking for.
That's exactly what you're looking for.
Shine and sparkle.
The damage shit.
You never know. You know?
Oh, look at your dick's getting hard.
He likes them big old bitties.
He's already making reservations on his phone.
Hey, she's crazy.
It's for Airbnb. No, I'm fucking around.
He's ordering some new rope. All right.
Yeah. I guess it's this.
You act like I'm the picture of fucking sanity over here because I'm not, bro.
Right.
No one. Well, after that conversation, no one thinks you're the picture.
There are countries on this planet where they would put me in prison just for being me.
Oh, I need to turn this off.
What does that mean? You said a lot. So what does that mean?
We're locking him up for being sexy.
This planet where they'd lock me up just for being who I am.
Like,
why are you being super vague, dude?
Why are you being cryptic? Like, do I have to guess? Do I have to give you options? Like, for what? For being black?
It's the cipher,
for being
man.
Muslim, for
no,
being...
no, no, I'm not Muslim. It's for like the BDSM.
Wait,
that was a rumor that was started years ago.
By who?
And it's not true.
Q?
No, I think it was Tim that started it.
That he's a Muslim?
You perpetuated that.
I heard you say that before.
You're always talking about how you're training with the Muslim Brotherhood.
Used to be.
Oh, so you're not. You used to be a Muslim.
A long time ago.
Okay, so.
So don't pretend like you were never, and don't try to say I'm writing a false narrative.
I said I'm not now.
That's not what you said first. You said don't be saying that I'm not.
Yeah, I said I'm not a Muslim.
Okay.
That, as in not now.
But you used to be one.
Used to be.
Okay, then.
I used to be a baby, too, but I grew out of that shit.
I used to be fucking a Jehovah's Witness.
My condolences.
Well, my condolences for being a Muslim.
I accept.
I used to be sane.
Are you still a spick, you dirty spick?
Yeah, no, I'm not a... Who,
disconnect.
That's another thing that's a bit of fabrication. I'm not a...
disconnect me.
I'm not a fucking Puerto Rican.
Yeah.
I don't know how this Puerto Rican thing came either. I don't know how that even... Oh, is that who that was?
Yeah, his racist mind jumped to Puerto Ricans.
Yeah. And then freaking Chris always exits on too. He always calls me Puerto Rican. I don't know why, but.
What's your last name? Puerto.
Just. Oh. That's literally. There's Puerto Vallarta. There's Puerto. he went straight to Puerto. Like, that's.
Well, this is honest.
Is it Puerto Rico?
Oh, Puerto Vallarta. Puerto. Oh, there's a bunch of Puertos. Well, I can't think of anyone, but.
Puerto Media.
But. Puerto Rico is easier.
God.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
And
I guess Rico is kind of one of those Americanized Spanish words
Puerto
that everybody's familiar with.
Are we on a troubleshooting break?
No, I'm trying to. How come it's not playing, Chris?
The what?
The music.
My sound.
You want me to just play Hott Nutts?
This one?
There it is.
Uh-huh.
And then you have to change the...
Hott Nutts. Anybody here want to buy my nuts? Nutts. Hott Nutts.
I've got nuts for sale.
Right,
1 for $5,
2 for $10.
If you buy them once, you'll buy them again. Sell the nuts.
Selling nuts.
What kind of nuts?
Hott Nutts. Anybody here want to buy my nuts? Selling nuts. Hott Nutts. I got nuts for sale.
How much are they?
10 for $5, 2 for $10. Okay. If you buy them once, you'll buy them again. Selling nuts.
Those are some cheap nuts.
Hot nuts. You buy them from the peanut man. Selling nuts.
They didn't go up with deflation. Hot
nuts. Anybody here want to buy my nuts? Selling nuts. Hot nuts.
Is it Russian?
I got nuts for sale.
No, baby. These are all American.
Tell me your nuts is mighty fine, but I bet your nuts ain't as hot as mine selling nuts.
Does Putin have nuts?
Hot nuts. You buy them from the peanut man.
No nuts for Putin.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, welcome to this special St. Patrick's Day edition of Hot Nuts.
St. Patrick's
Day. Everybody here knows. What the fuck's going on with Hot Nuts? For those of you playing at home,
no,
we got 3 news stories.
Did you just lose your collar?
Yeah, Tim ripped it off. Remember,
he is healed.
You move your neck like nothing was going on.
My neck is hurting a lot right now.
Sure,
he slipped out of character because he got into the story he's telling.
For those of you playing at home.
Yeah, Sean's neck brace is the fake story.
That's the fake story.
That's the fake story.
For those of you playing at home, I got 3 stories. One of them is fake. You have to identify which one is the fake one.
The one that when you fell down those stairs.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. Story number one.
The one when somebody else took your money.
Story number one. On St. Patrick's Day 2010, the First State Bank in Gallatin, Tennessee, was held up by a man wearing all green, a fake red beard, and a large hat. Who was presumably looking for a pot of gold at the end of a rainbow. Yes, this bank robber was dressed as a leprechaun. Police said gunman David Christopher Cotton scored an undisclosed amount of cash before leaving the bank. He then joined another suspect in a car outside, and the two fled. Cops spotted the vehicle and gave chase, and a wild gunfight broke out. A police cruiser was hit by several bullets and disabled. The pursuit continued with other units until the other two suspects crashed, ditched their car off the highway, and fled on foot into a field. The driver was shot to death by police fire, and the bank gunman shot himself in the head as the cops closed in. All the money was recovered from the abandoned vehicle, which had a large leprechaun hat in the backseat.
Love you.
Okay. Story number two. On St. Patrick's Day 2002.
Is that an intervention? Yeah.
Yeah. That was a great one.
All right. St. Patrick's Day 2022.
The guy was black, right? Yeah.
43-year-old Javier Amato kidnapped a 26-year-old woman from her apartment because he thought she was a leprechaun. The woman, who at 4'1" is legally considered a dwarf, testified that Amato bound her hands with his belt and locked her in the trunk of his car.
Ansel.
Amato claimed in court that he didn't think he did anything wrong at the time. According to his story, he was binge drinking with his friends.
Ansel.
And stepped out to his car to smoke a cigarette and make a phone
leprechaun.
Call.
Leprechaun. Look at the leprechaun.
No.
When, get in my trunk, leprechaun.
When he returned, he entered the wrong apartment, and upon his discovery of what he thought was a leprechaun, he had planned to force the woman to lead him to a pot of gold. Commissioner Nicholas Nauer said that despite the woman's appearance, Amato's statements didn't change his assessment that he's a grave risk to the community. He ordered him jailed in lieu of $750,000 bond on suspicion of kidnapping, false imprisonment, and burglary. Okay, story number 3.
You Nosferatu-looking motherfucker!
On March 18, 2012, the day after citywide St. Patrick's Day celebrations, a crowd of over 40 revelers gathered around a tourist in downtown Baltimore and beat, robbed, and stripped him of his clothes. The victim, who was intoxicated at the time of the incident, was 31-year-old John Grigsby from Alexandria, Virginia, and was on his way back to his hotel when the attack occurred.
So now, was he the leprechaun, or was the people who beat him the leprechauns?
There's
no leprechaun. They were all leprechauns.
I don't think there's a leprechaun in this one.
You know what I'm saying?
All right. So, among the stolen items were the keys to his Audi, his iPhone, his Tag Heuer watch valued at over $1,400.
Okay, this is the big story.
He woke up the next morning with injuries that included a fractured skull, missing teeth, lacerations to his face and torso,
yeah.
and several broken ribs.
No way.
Grigsby had no recollection of what had occurred. He was also unaware that the video had video was shot and uploaded of the attack and had been viewed over 500,000 times. After the video appeared online, amateur social media sleuths used tools to identify and track down the assailants. At least one turned himself in. And another three were arrested. They have served terms from 1 to 3 years in prison. All right, so just a quick recap. Story number one was a bank robbery in Tennessee by a leprechaun. Story number two was a kidnapping of a woman who a guy thought was a leprechaun. And story three,
I like that story. It was a good, it was a heartwarming tale.
And story number three was the man who got...
Well, he had a dream.
Beat.
He had ambition.
Yeah, the fake story, you mean.
At a St. Patty's Day celebration.
How much is that watch? Like $27,000?
I don't know. I put the story.
Yeah, that sounds like a fake story to me.
Cool.
Yeah, sounded fake to me, too.
Pat, what do you think?
I'd say number one.
No, that's real.
Pat's going with number one. Durf, what do you say?
Okay, I think... maybe number three. That one sounds pretty fake to me.
Yeah.
All right. One and three. All right, Jeff.
I'm going to go with number three.
Number three for Jeff. Oh, yeah. Chris.
Four
for Chris.
Number four.
Ansel.
I say number three is a fake one because it didn't have no leprechaun in it.
Three for Ansel.
Oh,
Isaac.
Oh, yeah. I've been saying three for the fucking... One more time. What were they calling me?
Paging Dr. Faggot.
All right. Perfect.
Okay.
I'm here to say that Dr.
Isaac said number one for Isaac.
No, I said number three.
Oh, number three for Isaac, yeah. Sorry. Tim?
Oh, number three, dude.
Number three, okay. The correct answer is number two. Nobody got it right.
Because Ansel did that before.
It was Ansel's favorite story, and it was completely fabricated.
Dude,
see, I think you made that shit up to get back at me for fucking with you today. I don't trust you. Your impartiality as a producer has been taken away.
Yeah, I don't trust that either. I think I got it right, though.
Yeah, I think
I'm going to be like Trump. I won this.
Yeah. Tim's going to win.
Wrong.
Tim's going to
win.
Tim's
I won.
Win.
The whole
Tim's
thing was staged.
Win.
Dude, did you see they took Trump off? They took Trump with the Nelk boys off?
Yep.
These guys are just fucking relentlessly retarded. There's just another level of... or retardation.
I thought that was
on.
One of the weirdest interviews I've ever seen, though.
It was pretty weird.
It went left field.
It was
quick.
Weird, but it was still informative. It was
to
was figure
telling.
Out who he was. But
I
he didn't even do
telling.
Nothing. What did he do? What can they possibly take off?
It's the liberal media, Timothy. It's liberal media. They don't.
People are little bitches. I bet you just got mass reported, huh?
Yeah, they just complain.
They're
about
like the troll. They like to swat the comment sections of the boards. You know, they're crazy, crazy people. Very crazy. But you should go like it, subscribe to the channel.
I mean, what happened to the good old days where we would just have a good old-fashioned book burning? Oh, wait a minute.
It's the same thing. Same thing.
Sorry. I like barbecue books. They're great, great, great
sorry.
Books.
Yeah,
I love a great book.
Shit.
I love a great book, just like the Art of the Sale. You know what I'm saying? Great, great, great book.
Right, Trump? What do you think?
These people are crazy. I tell you, they're just, Timothy, there's this great, crazy, crazy people. But I'm going to tell you about now, Crazy Joe. It's going to get crazier.
What's going to happen?
It's going to get very crazy. These people, they're good. You're going to see, this is a catastrophic failure. It's a catastrophic. Thank you.
Sorry.
A catastrophic failure, Timothy. You're going to see skyrocketing prices on barrels of gas.
America.
Just paid $6.04 today.
Yeah, it's crazy, Timothy. The poor American people are going to see. And then Crazy Joe don't care. He doesn't care. He slid his ivory castle. And Kamala Harris is a total disaster. She's laughing at all the questions. CNN is going down. Fox News is only asking the crazy questions.
Well, ask Ansel what they say on CNN.
listen, NBC, CNN, Daylight NBC, all these channels that Ansel watch, you know, all the criminals.
Oh, of course.
All the people, they all know what's going on.
Yeah, don't forget the Young Turks.
The Blaze. I really love what the Router and Crowder is doing. It's great, great stuff. That Shapiro, it's a great guy. Great, 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 great.
Young Turks? Is that left leaning?
Oh,
no, they're
what nice things that they said at my presidency.
They're kind of like, fuck everybody.
Yeah.
Okay. Time is on their side.
Those are the color, if you know what I mean. They're very colorful people.
Oh, they're...
They're of color, kind of yes, people? Yes, yes. Oh, yeah. They're, no, they're Turkish, they're, but, you know.
Most of them are... Well, I mean, they got some black folk on there.
Yeah. Oh, they do?
A couple, yeah.
They got any, like, his color?
Yeah.
Dark white. Do they have any dark white people?
Do they have, like, his color?
Yeah, there's a couple of...
There's a Latino.
There's some Latinos.
Yeah.
What about that?
Latinas. I didn't see any Filipinos.
With the Filipinos.
No. Do you see any racist white guys on there?
No, you ain't going to find that.
Wow.
Did you see any boring
racist
people?
White guy. You any pointed boring? To me instead of Sean. That's
well, you are wearing the
that's fake news
you,
right there.
You are wearing aviators.
Aviators.
Oh, come on,
and you
come
did,
on, man.
And you did have red shoelaces for
you,
a couple years.
Well, like I did, to be
I mean,
fair, I didn't
need,
know that that was a thing.
A, like uh-huh, the black sure. flight jacket okay. with the orange inside.
But he had red shoelaces
he
for 2 years.
Like
I didn't know.
Racist.
I didn't know about that
a very
until
young
after.
Joe Biden. A very young Joe Biden.
Come on, man.
That's what you kind of look like.
Chip. I don't know how to do his voice, really.
But young, what, Joe Biden in the 30s?
Sleepy, sleepy Jeff.
What did you learn?
We got it.
Oh, Pat. I learned.
Not,
oh,
you
me?
Durf?
Okay,
fuck, pay attention.
I remember my
same
first
brain.
Podcast.
Today I learned that...
Durf's annoying.
Yeah, Durf is pretty annoying.
He just fucking just overstepped you. I was like, hey, like, you are nobody, you know what I mean?
Durf is fucking high, let me tell you that shit
hey,
right
fuck
now.
You, Durf.
Derp.
No, that's your new name, Derp. When you get your tags, when you get your tags, it's going to be Derp.
Perfect.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
He doesn't have a leash.
Put a muzzle on that bitch.
He's too fucking high to get away from him, man. He's fucking lit right now, bro.
Head up his asshole. What are you talking about?
I'm pretty sure he had to take a good amount of heroin before he could fit the whole
hand. How was your week, Pat?
Oh, God. That was my
finish your week from last week for Jeff.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I want to know how it was.
God. No, what I learned is that I learned that you can fake an injury and be kind of convincing until you move. That's what I learned today.
Oh, and stop the shot of this guy?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That's why I stopped the shot of him. They know he's faking.
They're real injuries.
Fuck you, Sean.
Real
faking. Uh-huh. Sure.
All right, Derp. Go ahead. What did you learn now?
I learned today that Hott Nutts is a 1 in 3 chance of winning, and I technically picked 2 different answers and still lost.
Jeff, what'd you learn?
I learned that I make weird facial cues to make people upset, and I was unaware of that.
Not weird, cunty. Cunty.
Yeah, that was the word, cunty.
Cunty facial cues. And it offends people sometimes. So,
no, it didn't offend me. It's just I get worked up.
You know, I'm sorry. So
it's just how I am. I'm emotional.
Just ask
sorry.
Next time. Say, hey, Jeff, you being a cunt? And I'll say,
well,
yeah.
Well, I didn't know
not.
Until Tuesday.
Well.
And then you were being a dick on Wednesday.
You could have called me up and said, hey, what's your problem?
No. That's why I just did it here before we went on air.
Well, okay. Yeah. Maybe.
Ansel, how was your week?
wait a minute. I think that already happened.
What'd you learn, Coffee?
What did I learn?
What'd you learn, dude?
I learned that the Red Light District Show is currently looking for a new producer. So if you are interested, please contact Tim Amoroso on Facebook.
And that's good with money.
Or even mediocre with money. I'll settle for that.
Preferably someone who is not able to use credit cards.
Or how about has that? A gambling addiction.
No one with a gambling addiction at all.
If you have a problem with gambling, call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Or is better on stairs.
That's preferably. The word from on high.
Stairs are tricky.
Isaac, what'd you learn?
I learned that you can't fuck with Bill anymore because he fucking gets all crazy.
Man, I got fucking pissed. I got worked up today.
I could see what you mean about how you are very confrontational nowadays.
No. I'm always like that with him.
Oh, but I think it took it to a next level. No, that's just a normal, everyday thing. Well, fuck me.
I'm tired. Yo, I'm tired of people being mad about nothing.
Yeah.
Like Dennis was doing that for a long time. Like today, I thought you were on the tip now too, because of the conversation that about. I thought you were on the tip too, and I just saw that
because of last week. Expressions.
Nope. Yes, because of the cunty expressions. Yes. I'm sorry.
And then my dad did it, so there's three people. I had to fucking make a precedent. This was alphas do.
Yeah, he had
when I noticed that the group is getting out of line, I fucking peacock up.
I don't think it's the group. I think it's individual people that have done that. Like, I think it all, and I think the furthest way down it started with, I mean, I hate to reference more people, but there's a certain girl on the show, and then you were telling her the truth, and then they were like, nah, that's not true. So I can see how that can spin off.
Hey, that's what you guys witnessed today was alpha shit. I'm sorry you had to witness that.
Dick on Facebook.
Oh, Alex that guy. Vocal?
Fuck it.
I don't fuck with him no more.
There's a guy on Facebook?
Did you,
who's the
he's
guy
just
on
trying
Facebook?
To argue. See, and he admitted to it, so I thought it was.
This
I told
is what
him to fuck
I meant
off.
About your friends. Yeah. This is exactly what I read. Yes. When I wrote that, that's what I meant. Your fucking little fucking friends.
Who's on Facebook?
I have a lot of liberal friends.
Yeah, MSNBC friends. You know, Fox in the mornings.
It's same guy in the same band with fucking Mike Fuse.
I know.
The same reason why I don't get along with Fuse.
That's why. I thought it was like they
were
friends.
They are friends. They're in the same band. And I don't like that. I think that's sort of, like the whole arguing thing is dumb. Don't do it.
They're gay, huh?
I'm not saying that, dude.
Yeah, no one said gay, Chris. Jesus Christ.
I've already said, like,
this is not
paging Dr. F word on here through a drop.
I mean, we already did the drop. I mean, what's wrong with saying
gay bill?
No, no, it's because it's not me. It's not us.
Don't say gay bill. Pass to Florida.
All right.
Or don't say things that make white people feel uncomfortable.
From black people.
What'd you learn, Sean?
What?
I learned I'm going to have your money next week.
Yeah, hell yeah, you are.
Yeah.
Listen, I owe $81 a month on that credit card. All just right, pay me $81 right. a month for fucking 5 years or something.
I mean, I'll just get my tax return. I'll probably pay you back one, like...
We don't even have to do the $4,000.
You want to drag it out to, like, 81 payments?
Whatever you want to do, dude. All
right, if you're cool with that.
I don't want to be the alpha again next week, right?
Listen.
I had to bark at Jeff and Phil.
Listen, I'll bring your money. All right, I'll go to rehab. I'll do whatever it takes. All right.
What he's saying, Sean, is that it hurts him more than you get hurt when he has to hurt you. Yeah, when he has to hurt you, it hurts him more than it hurts you.
The Stewie Griffin.
But it's for your own good. Because if you don't learn this lesson of responsibility, someone who's less responsible than us might end up being the one you owe money to.
Yeah.
And especially if Ansel's in the room, I got to do something, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm just gonna
defend his turf for me.
Ansel's from the streets.
Yeah.
If he sees me back down from
you,
he's gonna come after me.
All right.
Immediately.
So I had to do it.
Like no question about it.
I will bring your money.
And that's good. That's good for him. That someone is around that will do that because it keeps him on his alpha game. You know,
Sean, your neck's working pretty well.
My neck.
I think you've been healed.
Yeah, I don't think you were in the hospital for 7 days or 8-9 days.
Restricting my neck. All right, and now.
Oh, so now.
By the mighty power of the Lord, he's healed.
I'm like a fucking life coach.
You know what? You guys wear that thing for a week and a half. See how you
know what's funny? You still have your glasses on.
You can fuck off.
I used to wear a corset.
Oh yeah, fuck you, Jeff.
Guys, give us a like, follow, subscribe, comment, and fade to black. The crowd goes fucking apeshit.
Wild.
And as they say in Canada, peace.